that as far, anything different than what you did like 89 when you had a ball club that won it and had a game left and had some real bad physical problems and tired and all that kind of thing?
Well, we had a couple players really banged up in 89 and a couple more that were just tired. And I don't know, Don, we had a two-game lead going into that last game at Iowa City, a two-game lead over Illinois. I think we'd won 15 games, and Illinois had won 13 going into the last game. I chose to rest our players, and I think that proved to be a really good thing. I felt that we played very well out in Tucson, and maybe I don't know, that was a funny seeding thing by the NCAA. We had lost Illinois twice, and we had Illinois, I think, in maybe the next to last game at home, or the third game from the end, I guess, down by 14 points with 6 or 7 minutes to play, and just got tired, and the game got away from us, and they won, went on to be a first seed in the NCAA tournament as the second place finisher in the Big Ten. I felt we were in the best position possible because of what we did. And yet on that team we had 12 or 13 players. Here we really don't have, with Henderson out, we don't have a real complement of big players to stay with the ball game, to make the game competitive. We've had a lot of guys playing. We're pretty well rested. I would think, Don, that we would play this game, except if, depending upon how the game goes, I would think that we would play this game fairly close to how we would play any game over the course of the season. I can see where there would be some things that would arise that might cause us to deviate from that plan a little bit. But I would think basically going into the game, we'll start the ball game with Greg Graham and Chris Reynolds, Bailey Chaney and Nover, go from there, and we'll certainly substitute and play and get people playing time. But I'm not so sure that will be any different than what we've been doing.
Coach, best of luck at today's ballgame. This has been the Bob Knight pregame show with discussion and commentary on today's game with Wisconsin. Now this is Don Fisher inviting you to stay tuned for today's broadcast.
As a public service, the Internal Revenue Service would like to answer some of its most frequently asked questions. For instance, do all Treasury agents have to wear those dark sunglasses? Come on, just kidding. Okay. First question, do I have to file a tax return? Well, that depends on your income received, your filing status, and age. See your tax package. Number two, do I have to report income from moonlighting jobs? Yes, you do. Number three, how can I check the status of my refund? Call the IRS teletax number in your tax package. Well, time for a little break, huh? Okay, question number four. Can I get the earned income credit? Yes, if you work and earn below $22,370 and a child lives with you. All right, number five. If I pay alimony, can I deduct it? Yes, you can. For any tax question, call the IRS at 1-800-TAX-1040. The IRS, answers, assistance at your service. Oh, and do Treasury agents have to wear those dark sunglasses? No, no, no. But they do have to stand around with their arms folded. Yeah, thank you.
Garlic is a good idea. And now Kwai odor-free garlic tablets give you all the goodness of garlic without the problems. Kwai concentrated garlic tablets are tiny and easy to swallow. Kwai's special scientific coating takes it gently through your stomach to prevent the odor and burping you get from other garlic preparations. So make garlic part of your everyday diet with Kwai. Garlic is a good idea, and Kwai odor-free tablets give you all the goodness of garlic without the problems. Kwai, K-W-A-I, at drug, health food, and GNC stores.
What?
The thing is, there are still interesting stories left to tell. Like the story of Custer's last stand from the viewpoint of the Sioux and Cheyenne. What it's like to see your own planet from 200,000 miles away. Or why the highly advanced Maya civilization ended up collapsing. Now and tomorrow, you can only see these stories on public television. They each contain pieces of our own history and are worth telling. Public television. It can only happen with your support.
Hi, I'm Larry Gentry, and I'm working for the New Market Christian Church in the Montgomery County March of Dimes Walk America on May the 1st. Nope. You can join us in this 6-mile walk to help prevent birth defects. We do need more walkers and non-walkers volunteers. Call Jackie Thompson or Sherry Stout at the National City Bank in Crawfordsville for more information. Call 362-3400. Thank you.
You're listening to 1550 AM WCVL and 103.9 FM WIMC Crawfordsville.
From Wisconsin Fieldhouse on the campus of the University of Wisconsin in Madison, this is exciting Indiana University basketball. Today's game is brought to you in part by Indiana Gas. For efficiency, comfort, and a cleaner environment, natural gas is your best energy value season after season. By your local Napa Auto Parts store, Napa because there are no unimportant parts. By your local Amoco Certicare Repair Centers. By the Hoosier Lottery, where you've got to play to win. By State Farm Insurance, the more than 500 State Farm agents throughout Indiana, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By the real estate professionals at the 121 Century 21 offices in Indiana. By True Value Hardware, got a tough job? You can do it with True Value Hardware stores. By Tricep Herbicide, PPI weed control that puts you in control. And by Indiana's Rural Electric Cooperatives, consumer-owned for service excellence. Hello again, everybody. This is Don Fisher along with Max Gerben. This afternoon, the Hoosiers pull down the curtain on brilliant regular season play, meeting the Badgers of Wisconsin. Ranked number 2 in the country with a 27-3 record and already owning the Big Ten title at 16-1, Indiana will be simply trying to maintain momentum as they await the seeding and pairings for the NCAA tournament scheduled for late this afternoon. Meantime, the Badgers at 14-12 and 7-10 in the conference are basically playing for a shot at the NIT. The all-time series dominated by IU with 79 wins to Wisconsin 46, but it's owned by Indiana the Night Years with a 38-4 mark that includes a Hoosier win streak that is currently at 25 in a row. We'll be back to talk more about today's game in a moment, but first, let's pause for the 60-second network timeout.
This is the sound of a car broken down on the side of the road. The driver is thumbing his way to the nearest Napa Auto Parts store. Too bad he didn't think about that sooner. You see, we carry over 125,000 different parts. So if anybody can help him get back on the road fast, it's Napa. Napa, because there are no unimportant parts.
In the Hoosier State, State Farm is there, helping Indiana families stay up to date. A State Farm agent is there to help you keep up with your changing insurance needs. Auto, home, life, and health. Ask about a free family insurance checkup now. From Angola to Washington, a State Farm agent is there to help you keep all your coverages up to date.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Well, here at Wisconsin Fieldhouse, as we get set for basketball this afternoon, Indiana, the Wisconsin Badgers. Max, we're going to get things underway fairly quickly here today, but we do want to just make mention, of course, the fact that the Wisconsin Badgers are a much improved ball club over the past few years.
Don, they are, and I think they're catching Indiana absolutely at a perfect time as far as their season is concerned. The Hoosiers have won the championship. There is very little to gain as far as Indiana is concerned except another win in the win column, which is certainly important. But if Wisconsin could pick a time, I think today would be the right time.
Wisconsin has struggled in recent ball games. They've lost 3 in a row, including defeats at the hands of 2 teams in the bottom of the Big Ten, Penn State and Northwestern.
Yeah, that's right, and that's kind of unusual because they had things going for themselves pretty well until they ran into that wall with those two teams. I'm sure that's had to have an adverse effect on their play.
Yep, they are very quick, full-court pressing ball club, and from what Steve Malchow, their sports information director, told us prior to the ball game, he felt strongly that this team wasn't physically tired, but maybe they had mentally hit the wall.
Well, they may have, and those two losses certainly has to have an effect on you mentally.
One of the things about Indiana going into today's ball game, Max, that we haven't seen on the road recently, Alan Henderson made the trip.
He did indeed. Of course, that six-second playing time he got the other night got everybody excited. And I would have to say, after watching him practice a little bit, he is making strides. But whether he's going to be able to play any at all this year still remains to be seen.
Well, we'll take a look at the starting lineups in a moment. But first, let's pause for the 60-second break. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Puritan Water Conditioning has installed units in hundreds of households in Montgomery and surrounding counties, as well as dozens of commercial establishments. Ask your favorite plumber about a Puritan. He'll tell you that a Puritan will eliminate lime, rust, odor, calcium, and iron deposits and makes water heaters and plumbing last much longer. Puritan has the right unit for you. Call them at 362-6340 for a free water analysis, or stop in at 216 Lafayette Avenue, Crawfordsville. Puritan, known for top quality and service.
Some home equity credit makes people uneasy, but not Equity Reserve at National City Bank. Equity Reserve is a no-nonsense, variable-rate credit line for fiscally responsible people who use common sense and good judgment. Right now at National City Bank, you can receive 7.75 APR and no closing cost. Appraisal fee may be assessed. So stop by a nearby National City Banking office to apply for your Equity Reserve credit line. Then relax. National City Bank, going the distance for you at all Montgomery County locations and equal housing lender.
Well, once again, here at Wisconsin Fieldhouse, it's Indiana and Wisconsin's Badgers in the Big Ten windup for the 1993 campaign, one in which Indiana has already toasted the Big Ten championship as theirs. And certainly, they're looking for bigger and better things in the NCAA tournament that will be announced this afternoon as far as the seeds and the pairings are concerned for this year's NCAA tournament field. That, of course, exciting news. Max, I don't think what Indiana does here today will be really or have any real bearing on what the outcome of those seedings are.
Well, that seems to be the general consensus. Of course, you never know what's really going on out there in Kansas City, but that seems to be the consensus that it will not make any difference. But I'm sure Indiana's going to try to make this a win in the win column so they take no chances.
Brian Evans has had a little bit of a problem this morning.
When we came down, he was having breakfast, Don, and he had some sunglasses on. I talked to Tim Garl just briefly, and he said he woke up this morning with some kind of an eye problem, and I frankly don't know what the problem is, but he is having some problem with his eyes.
Right now, Bob Knight is over there talking with Eric Carmen and Tom Rucker, two of the three officials that are on hand here today. He always tries to get a laugh out of them before a ball game and almost always never fails.
He does indeed. I understand Eric Harmon will be one of the officials in the Big Ten tourney. I would suspect that perhaps...
The Big Ten tourney?
Big Ten, yeah. In the NCAA tourney. I just heard that this morning, and I'm sure a couple of the others will also be there.
Right now, of course, we are awaiting for the introduction of the starting lineups this afternoon. One thing we do know, Max, about Wisconsin, despite the fact that they have struggled in recent ball games, this team is capable of beating anybody on a given day.
Well, they really like to get the ball, push it out. They like to score. They've scored over 100 points in four different games this year. They're a very up-tempo team as compared to what they used to be here, and that's really caught the imagination of the fans, but it's in keeping with Stu Jackson's style.
They've also had a few sellouts this year. Normally, Indiana's about the lone sellout. This year, I think this is maybe the sixth one.
Well, they've got one here today. I talked to some people in the hotel who paid $75 a ticket. You got to want to see a ball game, don't you, to see that?
Well, right now, the senior players in this ball club are presenting gifts to the parents of the respective seniors, and they are being introduced to the crowd here as well. So we're still a few moments from getting underway. Let's take a quick look at the starting lineups in today's ballgame. First of all, for Wisconsin, at the guard spot, they'll go with Tracy Webster, a 5'11", 178-pound junior out of Harvey, Illinois, who averages 14.3 points a game. At the other guard spot will be Andy Kilbride. He is 6'3", 184, a sophomore of Kankakee, Illinois. He averages 6.2 a contest. In the middle, Damon Harrell. 6'9", 224. He's a senior from Madison, Wisconsin. He averages 4.9 a ball game. And the forward spots will be manned by Michael Finley at 6'7", 192 pounds, a sophomore from Maywood, Illinois. He averages 22.1 a ball game, 23-2 in Big Ten play. The other forward will be Lewis Eli, a 6'7", 199-pound senior out of Harvey, Illinois, who is starting today. He is averaging 6.2 points per contest. For Indiana, Bob Knight is going with Damon Bailey at 6'3", 200, a junior out of Heltonville, a 10.5 scoring average. Calvert Cheney at 6'6", 204, a senior from Evansville, Indiana, 21.9 scoring mark. Matt Nover at 6'8", 230, a senior from Chesterton, Indiana, a 10.8 scoring average. And the guards will be Greg Graham at 6'5", 204, a senior out of Indianapolis, a 15.9 scoring mark. He's been on a tear of late. And Chris Reynolds at 6'1", 187, a senior from Peoria, Illinois, a 3.6 scoring mark. Max, I would assume one of the reasons Bob Knight is starting three guards today is to make sure that they do a good job against that full court pressure.
I think that's the answer, because the Badgers really do put a lot of pressure on the people bringing the ball up court. In three games just prior to the three they've lost, they were forcing 21 turnovers a game. So Indiana must control the ball as they bring it up court.
All right, we'll be back and talk more, or actually have the tip-off of this ball game in a moment. But first, let's pause for the 60-second network timeout.
To defend your soybeans against weeds, you need power. You need control. You need consistency. You need this squadron. Squadron Herbicide. For a higher level of soybean weed control, see your Cyanamid AgriCenter dealer. Read and follow label directions.
The Hoosier Lottery reminds basketball fans that you have to play to win.
Well, with 2 seconds left, the All-Stars are going to have to get the ball to star shooter Swish Sampson. Dave the Dribbler, Nelson inbounds, looking for Swish, but where is he? Oh, no, the Swishers on the sideline signing autographs. The All-Stars lose a heartbreaker, all because of a 7-foot ego trip.
Get in the game and win. Play the Hoosier Lottery.
Play the Hoosier Lottery's newest instant game. Crash the boards and pull down $1,000 instantly. There are three chances to win in this basketball game from the Hoosier Lottery.
Well, this broadcast is authorized under rights granted by Indiana University to University Broadcasting Company and the IU Radio Network. Any rebroadcast or the use of the descriptions and accounts of this game without the express written consent of University Broadcasting and the IU Radio Network is prohibited. We're about ready for the ball game to get underway today. One thing very interesting, Max, Greg Graham has been on such a tear of late, but it finally truly points out how good he has been in his 4 years at Indiana. He's now the number 10 career all-time scorer at IU, and that's playing second fiddle scoring-wise to a guy named Calvert Cheney.
He's kind of played in Cheney's shadow, of course, but I think the fact that when Henderson went down and some other things like that happened, Greg really picked up his game, and since that time, he has, as you said, have really been on a tear. Now Coach Knight wants to talk to the officials again. I don't know what the problem seems to be now, but he's got Stu Jackson coming over, too.
Bob Knight, Stu Jackson, and all three officials are now over there. As we said, the officials for today's game are Eric Harmon, Tom Rucker, and Phil Bova, who are slated to work this game this afternoon. And, of course, they're awaiting television to complete its timeout situation, and we'll be ready to go here momentarily. As Bob Knight has decided to go with three guards this afternoon, and that's how they'll start the ball game. But, of course, I'm sure we're going to see everybody in today's ballgame. A lot of speculation coming into today as to how Bob Knight would approach this. We asked him in the pregame, and he indicated very much like a normal situation rather than trying to rest too many people. Of course, the game will dictate, too, what goes on. Max, if they have a blowout situation either way, I'm sure we're going to see a lot more of some guys down the bench than we normally would.
I think that's right. He'd like to win those 17 games because he would then have all four teams who have won at least 17 games in Big Ten play. The three teams that have done it so far have all been Indiana teams also. So that's a goal they've got here today, to try to win 17 in the Big Ten.
Indiana, of course, now owning more Big Ten championships in the league than any other school. Bob Knight has 11, which has equaled War Piggy Lambert's mark of 11. And one more, and he'll surpass him. So it's been a tremendous run under Bob Knight in his 22 seasons at IU. This being Stu Jackson's first, he's got a lot of ground to make up.
He certainly has, but he's made some giant strides already this year.
They stand 14-10 as we're ready to go now. The tip-off at center court, Eli and Cheney. Tom Rucker will toss the ball. It's in the air, and it's controlled by Indiana. Off the mat and over, down to Chris Reynolds, and Reynolds across the timeline to the top of the key. A 2-3 zone being employed by Wisconsin to start the ballgame. Here is Graham bouncing it right side to Damon Bailey. Back out it comes to Reynolds. Now left to Graham. Graham drives it left wing. Pulls it back out to Bailey on the bounce pass to Reynolds. He drives, penetrates, jumps it into Nover, lays it up and in. Matt Nover's got Indiana's first two. And the Hoosiers immediately take the lead. Across the timeline, the scoreboard's not working here. In backcourt, it's Eli and Finley. Now into Harrell. Jump hook is no good. And the rebound comes off to Chris Reynolds. Back down the floor, across the timeline. Reynolds brings it outside. Cross courts it to Damon Bailey, to Calvert Cheney. Now right side to Chris. Chris comes back on the wing to Greg Graham on the right side. Back out to Reynolds, now to Bailey. He fakes, back to Chris. Now to Graham. He lets a three fly. It's short. Rebound pulled out of there by Kilbride. Andy Kilbride roars it down the floor, bounces it off to Webster. He behinds the back to Eli, and it's batted out of bounds by Greg Graham. Graham is saying he bounced it off of Eli's knee, but the officials don't buy it, and the inbound play will come from Wisconsin, but a good defensive effort nonetheless. David Harrell will inbound. Harrell looks it in, fires backcourt to Kilbride, who goes left to Tracy Webster. Webster now circles in backcourt. Webster directing some traffic out there. Bob Knight was questioning Tom Rucker about the call down underneath. Webster now on the right wing. Harrell just slammed into Greg Graham, gets the pass inside to Eli. Eli turns, fires it up, and got it. Lewis Eli gets his first two of the game to tie things up at 2-2. Now across the timeline, Greg Graham has it outside to Damon Bailey. Bailey now flips it away to Reynolds, who flies it off to Graham. Graham, top of the key, lobs it in to Calvert Cheney. Down low to Nover, up and in. Matt Nover gets his second easy basket, and the Hoosiers lead it 4-2. Now, across the timeline, Webster, outside to Harrell, bats pass to Kilbride. He's on the wing, gets it back top of the key to Finley. Finley goes to Webster, down low to Harrell. Harrell clicks it back out to Finley. Finley fires a three. It's no good, and the rebound comes down to Bailey. Damon brings it up the court. Across the timeline, left to Greg Graham in the corner. He lets it fly. He got it. Greg Graham cans his first three of the ball game. And Indiana now is on top by a 7-2 count. Now, left wing pass goes to Finley. He holds high, comes out to Kilbride. Kilbride, top of the key, gets it to Eli, and he travels. Turnover on the Badgers, and Indiana will get the turnover and the basketball. Going to be tough, Max, without a scoreboard.
Well, look at these columns. Indiana's on the left, Wisconsin on the right.
Up the floor. Across the timeline, Chris Reynolds, left side to Damon Bailey, back to Chris. Now outside to Graham. Graham, top of the key, inside the circle, gives to Reynolds, right wing to Calvert. He fires a three, no good. Rebound, batted away. Graham tried to save it, could not, and it'll belong to Wisconsin. IU leading 7-2. We are without a scoreboard, clock, or score signaling operation here. Our who fouls are on or anything. They're going to have to either get it fixed or I don't even know what they're doing, but there's no score anyplace. Not on any of the smaller scoreboards or anything. Now Webster across the timeline. Apparently knew it going in. Here's Kelly in backcourt. He has just checked in for Eli. Now off it goes. A jump shot from Finley. No good. Matt Nover's got the rebound. Here come the Hoosiers. Chris Reynolds takes it to the right side. In nice feed to Greg Graham for a left-handed reverse layup. Greg Graham has got five, and the Hoosiers are on top 9-2. Now, here's Kelly, goes left side to Finley, outside to Kilbride. Kilbride holds on Bailey. Back in the wing to Eli. He turns in, fires it up, missed the shot, rebound Calvert Cheney. Cheney will clear it away. He gives to Reynolds, and Chris will slide it up across the timeline to Damon Bailey. Bailey outside to Chris Reynolds, down to Greg Graham. Graham holds against the zone, now flips it off to Reynolds, inside to Nover, kicks it away to Bailey, three on the way, got it! Damon Bailey's got his first three of the ball game, and Stu Jackson wants timeout immediately. The score, Indiana 12, Wisconsin 2. We'll be back after this 60-second network timeout.
Great game for copyright, Bob.
And how about that star player, Bob?
Oh, the Canon NP6060 copier.
Fires a copy a second.
And the Canon NP6060 has amazing depth.
Holds a million sheets.
Now, Bob.
Okay, 6100.
Backed by professional service technicians.
Millions of them.
Bob.
Okay, a lot. And each has 70 years of experience.
Bob.
Well, five's the average.
Copyright. The smart choice.
The Canon NP6060 is just plain amazing.
And it's from Copyright. Call them today.
Hey, speaking of years, Bob.
Yeah, Bob.
Are those gray hairs I see?
Thinking of selling your home? Let the professionals at Century 21 ease the stress. Even under the best circumstances, selling a house comes with a certain amount of anxiety. The key to minimizing it is selecting a sales associate that has the knowledge and sensitivity to take you comfortably through the process, which is why you should contact one of the sales associates at your local Century 21 office or call 1-800-886-4849. Just tell us what you want. It's as good as done. Each office independently owned and operated.
Here at Wisconsin Fieldhouse, 16 minutes, 20 seconds remaining in the first half of play, and the Hoosiers are off to a quick lead at 12-2 for the 20th consecutive year IU basketball games, being brought to you over a statewide network of radio stations numbering over 50 strong, including WCOE in LaPorte, WTCJ in Tell City, WITY in Danville, Illinois, and Hoosier Hot 96 in Indianapolis. We're proud to have these stations as part of this year's IU Network. Hope you're enjoying today's broadcast.
Well, Indiana is off to a roaring start. They've hit 5 out of 7 shots, 71%. They've hit 2 out of 3 from three-point range. University of Wisconsin is 1 for 5 right now, just 20%, as Indiana has a 10-point lead at 12-2.
Well, back out of the floor, Indiana sends the same lineup. Well, yeah, it is. The same group is out there. Graham, Reynolds, Chaney, Nover, and Bailey. And the Wisconsin Badgers have Kilbride, Eli, Finley, Webster, and Kelly. Brian Kelly is a 6'7 sophomore from Decatur, Georgia, who has played a lot of ball and started many ball games this year. But today, Stu Jackson elected to go with Lewis Eli at a starting role, and now Damon Harrell is the guy sitting down who was replaced by Brian Kelly. So they don't have their quickest lineup in there, or rather they don't have their biggest lineup, I should say, but they certainly have a quick one as far as the Badgers are concerned, and likewise Bob Knight is countered with three guards as well.
Now we're waiting. They've got the scoreboard, part of it working. They're trying to get the Indiana score on it now. They've got Wisconsin's score up there, and the time is up there, 16:20 to be played in the first half, but they still can't get Indiana's to work, so we'll keep track of it.
So we're ready. And the inbound comes over to Wisconsin's Tracy Webster. He'll bring it up. Webster across the timeline. Moves it to the left side, drives to the baseline, puts it up, and it's blocked away out of bounds by Chris Reynolds. Good defensive job by Reynolds. So again, the Badgers will inbound from underneath their own hoop. Michael Finley will do the honors for the Badgers. 12-2 the score, Indiana on top. Inbound pass way in backcourt to Andy Kilbride. Kilbride on the dribble against Bailey, slides it into the lane, gives it off to Eli. Eli out to Finley. Finley looks inside, drives it right, or to the left rather, gets it into Kelly. Brian Kelly turns, he drives, he looks down low, he fakes, looks for help, he's in trouble, finally clears it away to Webster, who lets it fly, got it. Tracy Webster gets his first bucket, it's a 3. And it's now 12-5. Indiana on top by 7, full court pressure. Here's Reynolds breaking it to Calvert Chaney. Chaney in backcourt with a pass to Reynolds, who goes left side to Gray Graham, a man-to-man now being used by Wisconsin. Out comes Graham on the dribble, bounces to Chris Reynolds, right side. He brings it back left to Graham. Graham fakes, drives, and he is fouled by Kilbride. Got Kilbride to leave his feet with a nice shot fake, and Kilbride picks up the personal. That'll be his first of the ball game. So Indiana top by 7, 12-5, and Indiana will have it out of bounds. I think they announced Tracy Webster as the guy the foul was called on, but it was Kilbride. Here's Greg Graham pumping it up. No good. Rebound batted away by Bailey, and it's a foul call against Damon. Bailey reaching in to try and bat that rebound and picks up his first foul. So it's 12-5 Indiana. The Badgers have a chance to draw ever closer. Just underway in this ball game with 15-16 on the clock first half. Here's Tracy Webster bouncing to Kilbride on the right wing. Outside pass to Kelly. Back to Kilbride. Drives it back to Finley. Finley lets a 3 fly. He misses. The rebound inside goes to Madden over. And the Hoosiers have the board. Here's Greg Graham the other way. Graham slows in backcourt. Gives it to Bailey. He's down the lane. Kicks off to Reynolds. He drives. Puts it up and missed it. Rebound tipped up. Tipped again and Madden over got it. Madden over 6th point of the contest. 14-5 Indiana. Here's Kelly pulls up, doesn't take the shot, turns around, looks for help. Finally, he clears it away. It comes off to Webster. Tracy Webster to Kilbride, a three on the way, and he got it. Andy Kilbride gets his first basket of the ball game, and it's now 14-8. Here's Bailey the other way. Damon bounces it out to Calvert. Down inside to Reynolds. Reynolds bounces back to Nover, and he is fouled. Foul call will go, I believe, on Brian Kelly. We'll wait and see. Tom Rucker gave the signal. It is Brian Kelly nailing the personal foul. That'll be his first of the ball game. That's the second team foul whistled on the Badgers. The Hoosiers lead it by six, and Damon Bailey will inbound as Damon Harrell checks in, and Lewis Eli sits down. They lob it into Calvert. Calvert down low, fires it off the glass and hits. Calvert Cheney gets his first two. 16-8 Indiana. Bounce pass right side, Kilbride. On the wing, outside to Brian Kelly. He circles toward the left. Looks it in the corner, goes to Tracy Webster on the wing. Webster down low to Harrell. Harrell turns and clears it back to Kilbride, who goes to Finley. Finley fakes, drives, pulls up, gives it out to Webster. Webster fakes, back off to Finley. Finley again, driving it to the left side baseline, pulls up inside, shoots and got it. Nice job by Finley for his first field goal. And Indiana is fouled again. This is Brian Kelly getting number two. Brian Kelly picks up his second personal as Reynolds hit the deck again. Indiana leads 16-10, 13:44 on the clock first half, and the Hoosiers will have the ball out of bounds.
Wisconsin's been a little bit of a shooting slump the last three games, but they're showing signs of coming out of that here this afternoon. As they've hit a couple of three-pointers now. They're a team that shoots a lot of them.
Jeff Peterson, a 6'10 junior, is now in for McGuan, Wisconsin, averaging 5 points a ball game. And Indiana sends in Pat Graham for his first appearance in this one. Also, Brian Evans checking in for the first time, and Matt Nover sits down. So Nover and Bailey to the sidelines. Pat Graham and Brian Evans are in. Here's Chris Reynolds in backcourt. Chris, left side pass to Brian. Evans brings it inside to Greg Graham. Nice feed, and he missed the shot inside. Tried to get himself back out to get an angle at the shot and didn't get quite enough. Here is Peterson, who bounces it right wing to a new face in the game, Johnson. Here's Harrell putting a shot up and missing, but he is fouled. They're going to whistle Pat Graham, his first of the ball game. At the line will be Damon Harrell, a 6'9 senior out of Madison, Wisconsin, who averages 4.9 points a ball game. And he'll be at the stripe hitting 71% of his free tosses so far this season. Indiana leading by six, but the Badgers have a chance to cut it to four if Harrell can convert both, and he hits the first. Damon Harrell's first point of the ball game, and he'll have an opportunity for one more. 13:23 on the clock. Stu Jackson pacing the sidelines in front of the Badger bench. And Harrell got them both to drop. He's got two. Full court pressure applied. Greg Graham has it. And he'll bring it back out of trouble. Bounces to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds to Pat Graham. Pat in some trouble. Bounces it away to Greg Graham. A whistle and a walking violation on Indiana's Pat Graham. So the turnover is Indiana's first, and the Badgers have the basketball. So the full court press does its job that time. Inbound play comes Peterson to Webster. Webster now brings it up the court. Stu Jackson directing traffic out there. Tells Webster what he wants to do. This is Jason Johnson with the ball, top of the key. Johnson, right side pass to Finley. Finley drives on Cheney, spins, lost the handle. Finally picked it back up. Finley gives it out to Tracy Webster. Again to Finley. Finley drives it down low left. Kicks it outside to Johnson, and he fires and misses. Rebound batted up. Pat Grant had it knocked away. Finley's got it back, puts it up, and didn't get the roll. Got his own rebound and put it in. Michael Finley gets his fourth point. And the Hoosiers are leading by just two as Greg Graham breaks the press. Graham in the lane, scoops it up, and got it. What a move by Greg Graham. The other way, he's got seven. 16-14. Inside pass deflected out of bounds. It'll belong to Wisconsin. Badger ball. Indiana by four. 18-14 with 12:21 to go. Tell you what, the full court press gets the crowd into a frenzy.
It really does, especially when they cause the turnover.
Finley inbounds to Webster. Webster lets a three fly. Got it. Webster's second play, and it's 18-17. The Hoosiers lead by just one. Here's Greg Graham walking it up, now driving it across the timeline, gets it across, works it in backcourt to Pat Graham. Pat looks in, gives it out to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds, top of the key, left to Pat Graham for a three, missed it, rebound, Bryant Evans back up and in. Bryant Evans scores his first two, and a rebound bucket, it's 20-17. Indiana, a three-point leader. Here's Jeff Peterson to Michael Finley. Crosses into Peterson, and he is fouled by Bryant Evans. Evans got beat inside, and about the only thing he could do was foul Peterson pretty hard and make sure he didn't hit the layup. So Bryant picks up his first foul of the ball game. It puts Jeff Peterson at the free throw line for Wisconsin. And he's a good free throw shooter, hitting 76% of his shots from the stripe.
I tell you, that's the first one against Bryant, but I really thought the one Pat Graham got a while ago was Bryant Evans' foul, but they called it on Pat.
Pat Graham sits down as Todd Leary checks in for Indiana. And Matt Novers come back in as well. Here's a free one up, and it is around and no good. Jeff Peterson had the opportunity and missed his first attempt. He'll get one more. He can draw Wisconsin within two. Chris Reynolds and Pat Graham are the two that sat out for Nover and Leary. The second shot also no good, but the rebound is knocked away. Peterson back up and got it. So Peterson gets his own rebound and puts it in. Here's Calvert Cheney. Gets it in to Todd Leary. Back to Calvert. Calvert gives it back to Todd, and Todd will try to bring it down the court. Leary spins, gets it across the timeline. Leary in backcourt on the dribble. Slides it toward the left and comes back to the right. Stops his dribble, gives it to Calvert on the wing. Down low to Greg Graham, lost it out of bounds. And Indiana will have it. It was off of Johnson. And we get a timeout. The score reads Indiana 20, Wisconsin 19, with 11:15 on the clock. First half back after the 60-second network timeout.
Hi, this is Willard Scott for True Value. We'd like to recognize the Indiana University basketball team, better known as the Hoosiers, for their hard work all season. Lighting up the scoreboard in a basketball game means you have some great scorers. But lighting up every room in your home should be done with GE light bulbs. Because right now, you can get a pack of four soft white bulbs in 40, 60, 75, or 100 watts for just $1.31 at your local True Value hardware store or home center.
What's clear?
New Crystal Clear Amoco Ultimate Gasoline.
What isn't?
All other premium gasolines.
What's clear?
New Improved Amoco Ultimate is the only premium refined an extra step to remove harmful impurities called PNAs.
PNAs?
Impurities that can rob your engine of performance and contribute to hydrocarbon exhaust emissions.
What's clear?
For unsurpassed performance in a cleaner environment, Crystal Clear Amoco Ultimate.
New in this area.
You expect more from a leader.
Well, back once again at Wisconsin Fieldhouse, Indiana, 20, Wisconsin 19, 11:15 to go in this first half of play.
Well, Indiana, after it hit five out of the first seven, Wisconsin goes to a man-to-man, and now Indiana has hit four out of their last nine for the game. They're shooting 9 of 16, 56%. University of Wisconsin, which was 1 of 5 to start, is now 7 of 15. They've hit 6 out of their last 10. They are now 47%, but from three-point range, from three-point range, they're 3 of 6. Indiana, 2 of 5. The Badgers have made 6 of their last 9 shots. Rebounding is dead even right now, 8-8. However, on the offensive board, Wisconsin has been very effective and have put in some rebound scores here as Wisconsin has worked from a 10-point deficit to a 1-point deficit now, trailing just 20-19.
Damon Bailey has checked back in for Indiana. He replaces Greg Graham to give Graham his first rest of this contest. Indiana will have the basketball underneath their own hoop. Damon will inbound. Nover, Bryant Evans, Calvert Cheney, and Todd Leary, the other members of the group on the floor. Jeff Peterson, Damon Harrell, along with Michael Finley, Jason Johnson, and Tracy Webster, the lineup for Wisconsin. Inbounding will be Bailey. Damon fires it into Leary, who pumps a jump shot, and no, didn't get the roll. Halfway down and came back out again. Here's Tracy Webster the other way to Finley. Finley, back out it comes to Harrell. Left side to Johnson. Down low to Peterson. He turns, fires it up, scoop shot, no. Rebound, Bryant Evans. He clears it to Todd Leary. Across the timeline, Leary in backcourt. Takes it toward the left side, down to the wing. Looks, finally clears it out to Damon Bailey. Bailey holds in backcourt. Now gets it to Leary. Todd looks down low, can't find over. Dribbles with it once, twice, then bounces low to Calvert. He turns on Finley, scoops it inside. The ball out of bounds. It'll belong to IU. Touch last of there. Looked like by maybe Damon Harrell or Jason Johnson. Is the inbound to Bryant Evans. He bounces it back to Nover. Matt clears it outside to Todd Leary to reset the offense to Bryant Evans. Evans pulls it back out. Gives it to Calvert Chaney. Chaney outside to Todd Leary. Leary now off to Bryant Evans. Three on the way by Bryant. It's no good. The rebound long to Tracy Webster for the Badger. Down the floor, Webster driving on Leary. Pumps it up. Partially blocked, it looked like, by Leary. Evans came away. Off to Bailey. Stu Jackson screaming for a foul as Bailey throws it up and got it. Damon Bailey's got his fifth point. Indiana 22, Wisconsin 19. Jackson vehement about that lack of a call at the other end. Johnson to Peterson. Peterson now slides it left, pulls up, bounces into Michael Finley. Finley against Bailey. Finley drives, fakes, lost the handle. Nice defensive job by Damon Bailey. Bailey the other way. Damon slides it in the lane, gives it to baseline to Calvert. He pumps the shot, got it. Calvert Chaney's got his fourth point. Indiana 24, Wisconsin 19. Inside, Harrell puts it up. No good. Calvert Chaney did the job defensively. Here come the Hoosiers again. Here's Leary, driving it inside himself. He tries to scoop it up, and he draws the foul. And the Badger fans don't like the call, but Todd Leary did exactly what he should have done in that play. And he almost got himself out of control there, Max, because he had nothing to do. He had to be fouled, or he was going to go out of bounds or up and down.
You're right about that. He was going out of control. The thing I don't understand, I thought he'd get a shot out of that, but I guess they say he didn't think he was putting a shot up.
Brian Kelly and Adam Carl coming into the ball game for Wisconsin. Carl for the first time, a 5'11 junior from Northbrook, Illinois. The inbound to Bryant Evans. Now to Todd Leary in backcourt for IU. The Hoosiers lead by five. Here's Leary, left wing dribble. Lost the handle, got it back, gets it to Calvert Chaney. He looks, works on Finley, fakes, fires it inside to Leary. Back out to Bryant Evans. Long jumper in the way. Off the rim, no. Bryant goes after his own rebound. It's touched last by Evans. Evans has had a tough time finding his shot of late, especially the long outside jumper that he normally is very, very productive with. 24-19, Indiana five-point leader. Here's Carl driving him down the left side. Adam Carl against Leary, gives him the corner to Kilbride. Back out it goes to Finley, who fires it up and hit it. Michael Finley is some kind of shooter. He's got six. 24-21, Indiana three-point leader in the ball game as Leary starts it to the left, comes back out to Bailey. Damon slides it back to the right, comes back outside to Leary, now to Calvert, all alone, fires the three, and no good. Rebound comes away to Brian Kelly. Down the floor to Adam Carl. Carl on the left wing to Kelly, right side to Kilbride. Kilbride looks in. Now dribbles it once, looks for some help. Finally gets it into Finley, and it's stolen by Calvert Chaney, who saves it to Damon Bailey. Up the court to Todd Leary. Leary takes it in the lane. Scoop shot up on the left hand. He got the roll. Todd Leary has his first two. 26-21. Indiana by five again. Reynolds and Greg Graham are getting set to check back in for IU. Here's Kilbride to Peterson down low. And a whistle and a foul call. It's going to be on Nover or Evans. Looks like Bryant Evans called for it. That'll be his second personal foul. Here come Greg Graham and Chris Reynolds back in, and we get another timeout. Score, Indiana 26, Wisconsin 21, with 7:56 to go. First half of play, back after the 60-second network timeout.
I nestled into booth 12 at Waffle House when I heard that...
May I help you?
...voice. There stood the most pleasant, caring...
Nice haircut.
...person I'd ever met. Over the next hour, we shared...
I'd recommend...
...many thoughts.
Coffee.
...about life. You see, I had reached...
Dessert? Fishing tips?
...the service zone.
If we could be open more than day and night, we would. We're more than lip service. We're Waffle House.
I moved to booth 11.
Oh, miss.
When was the last time you thought about your electricity? Never, right? Well, there's a reason for that. It's called Indiana's Consumer-Owned Rural Electric Cooperatives. And we've been providing you and a million other people with reliable electric service for 55 years. And we've invested over $2 billion to bring you electricity for conveniences like TVs, refrigerators, toasters, and much more. Of course, there's a reason Indiana's rural electric cooperatives work so hard to serve you. You are, after all, our owners.
Wisconsin Fieldhouse, Indiana, enjoying a 26-21 lead over the Wisconsin Badgers with 7:56 to go in this first half of play.
Well, Indiana's shooting continues to drop off after that very torrid start. They were, of course, playing against the zone to start and getting some easy baskets. Wisconsin picked up its defense considerably. Indiana now shooting 52%. Wisconsin continues to struggle. They're hitting only 42% on 8 of 19, as both teams have not done well. Indiana hit 3 of their last 5. Wisconsin, 2 of their last 5. Wisconsin out-rebounding Indiana right now 12-11. But IU has taken 8 3-point shots already and hit only 2 of them. Wisconsin has taken 6 and hit 3. And, of course, that's been one of the significant things so far in this game. The other thing, Don, I think, is Wisconsin's done a pretty good job on Cheney right now. He's only gotten 4 shots, 2 of them inside, which he's hit, and these 2 3-pointers have been off the mark.
On the floor, IU has Calvert Cheney, Chris Reynolds, Greg Graham, Matt Nover, and Damon Bailey now. That's their original starting 5 for the day. And on the floor for Wisconsin, Michael Finley, Tracy Webster, Brian Kelly, Jeff Peterson, and Andy Kilbride. Kelly will inbound for the Badgers, who have possession underneath their own hoop. And Kelly looks to fire it in, gets it backcourt to Kilbride. Kilbride now slides it toward the right side. Pulls up, gives it off to Brian Kelly on the wing. Kelly looks low, can't find Webster, goes inside, and Chris Reynolds makes a great steal. Reynolds down, across the timeline, right side of Calvert Cheney. Calvert fakes the pull-up, then dribbles it, gives it off to Greg Graham. He fires the three, and he hits it. Greg Graham buries his second three of the day and his 10th point of the ball game already, and the Hoosiers now lead it 29-21. 8-point margin, Kilbride with the basketball. He looks, drives it right, comes back left, clears it away to Finley down to the corner right side. Finley now holds against Greg Graham, flips it back out to Peterson, who goes to Tracy Webster. Webster fakes the jump shot, now to Kelly, outside to Kilbride, down into Finley. Finley turns inside. Michael Finley drives, spins, pulls up, throws it up, missed the shot, and the rebound to Matt Mover. Off to Damon Bailey. Bailey slides it in backcourt to Greg or Chris Reynolds. He gives it off to Bailey. Bailey tried to drive it inside. He spins in the lane, fires it underneath the Matanover. Reverse layup is good. Matanover's got his 8 point. 31-21. The Hoosiers lead it by 10, their biggest lead of the ball game. Here's Brian Kelly. Nover's perfect on the day from the field. Kelly gets it to Webster, right side. 4 for 4 from Matanover. Here's Finley. Baseline. Back outside, pass to Kilbride. Almost thrown away. Kilbride slides it off to Kelly, back out to Finley. 3 on the way, no good, and the rebound to Matt Nover. Nover clears it out of trouble to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds up court to Greg Graham, down to Calvert in the corner. He lets it go, and he got it, a 3. Calvert Cheney's got 7. The Hoosiers now on a run, 34-21 the score. 13-point Hoosier lead. Finley back court to Kilbride, right side to Webster. Down in to Kelly. Kelly on the wing against Cheney. Turns, looks, clears it out to Peterson, to Finley. Left side to Webster. He drives on Bailey. Lets it fly, missed the shot. Rebound, Damon Bailey. Bailey down the floor, drives it all the way, scoops it up and scores! Damon Bailey, 7th point. 21. IU is on a run. 15-point lead. Right side Kilbride. Outside it comes to Webster. He tries to slow it down. Backs it out near the midcourt line. Now, starts it to the left side. Webster takes it down low. Looks in. Having trouble. Clears to Kilbride. 3 on the way. Got it. Andy Kilbride has got his average already with his second three-pointer. 36-24. Reynolds in some trouble. There's a double dribble. Double dribble called against Indiana's Chris Reynolds. And so Wisconsin will get the basketball back. The Hoosiers lead by 12, 5-12 remaining first half.
Well, Don, that's only Indiana's second turnover against this pressing defense, so they've handled the ball well.
Finley gets it in to Kilbride. Kilbride in backcourt. He gives it off to Tracy Webster. Webster now on the move to the left. Takes it to the wing. Looks in outside to Kilbride. Another three. Got it again. He's hit three of them. That's his third tray. Here's Greg Graham now to Chris Reynolds. They'll try to bring it up. Reynolds having some trouble. Gets it to Pat Graham, who's checked in. He drives in. Scoop shot. No. Tip up is good. I'm not sure who they're going to give the basket to, but it looked like goaltending, and everybody in the field house felt that way, too. Kilbride gets it outside to Tracy Webster. Indiana got a break there. In backcourt with the basketball, Webster drives it to the right side. Webster against Reynolds gets it off to Finley. His 12-foot jump shot is no good, but a foul. Pat Graham will get nailed on it. That'll be his second of the ball game. And we look up at the scoreboard. They've only got Madden over for 6 points, but he's got eight.
No, they got him for 10. You're on this side.
I'm looking at the wrong side. Yeah. So they did give it to Matt.
Right.
So Madden over is the guy they give it to, and he's 5 for 5. Nover with 10. And Finley at the free throw line for Wisconsin. Michael Finley, 6 points in the ball game. Most prolific scorer for this Badger ball club. He's got 7 now, and he'll get one more shot covered. Finley is hitting 76% of his free tosses this year. He's averaging 22.1 points a ball game. And Pat Graham will sit to the sideline as Todd Leary checks in once again for IU. Bailey is also down there. Nover, Cheney, Greg Graham, Chris Reynolds, and Todd Leary, the lineup now for IU. Second shot for Finley, also good. Michael Finley's got 8. Full court pressure applied. Calvert gets it in to Greg Graham. Up court to Todd Leary. Leary turns around. He'll bring it up the floor on the dribble. Against the trap. Slides, tries to get by. Finally clears it to Calvert. Now off to Greg Graham. Graham pulls up. 8-footer, no. Tips it in. Greg Graham with a tip in. He's got 12. 40-29. Indiana by 11. Backcourt, Damon Harrell. Off to Michael Finley. Back out to Kilbride. Now right side, it comes to Webster. He holds high. Tracy Webster off to Mike Finley on the right side. Finley holds. Now clears it outside to Harrell. Damon Harrell, top of the key, gives it back to Webster. Webster slides it in the lane, pulls up, gives it out to Finley. Finley drives it in the lane, fires a 14-footer. This time, no. Rebound, Madden over for Indiana. Down the floor to Leary. Up court to Greg Graham. Graham back off to Todd. Todd takes it inside, has it batted out to Graham, fires the shot, and he hit it. Greg Graham buries another. He's got 15 points, and he's got 3 trays that have dropped today. 43-29. Outside pass to Kilbride. Kilbride gives it off to Webster. Webster down the backcourt hold against Chris Reynolds. Now, Webster slides it right. Looking to move with it. Reynolds hopping him every step of the way. Got to be frustrating for Wisconsin. Here's Webster again with the ball on the left wing. Now outside to Kilbride. 3 up. And no good this time. Rebound to Greg Graham. Here come the Hoosiers. Graham to Madden over to Chris Reynolds. Back up and no good but a foul. Tracy Webster will be nailed on it. Webster picks up the personal. That will be his first of the contest. Indiana will be at the free throw line, leading it by 14 with 2:43 to go first half. As Chris Reynolds steps to the stripe with no points today, trying to pick up his first here.
Don, it's the first time Indiana's been the line all half.
And Chris at the line has 2 shots coming, the first of which is no good. He'll have one more. Jason Johnson will check into the lineup now for Wisconsin, and sitting down will be Andy Kilbride. Kilbride with 3 trays. Tell you what, there's a lot of three-point shooting going on in this ball game.
Certainly is. Kilbride hits almost half his 3-point shots. He's 3 of 4 today.
And Chris Reynolds hits this one. He's got his first point, and we got a timeout on the floor with a score. Indiana 44, Wisconsin 29. 2:43 left in the half. We'll be back after the 60-second break. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
It's true. For years, Zox was primarily known for their delicious variety of hamburgers, broasted chicken, and root beer. But have you been to Zox lately? Jim Zox has added filet mignon, T-bone, ribeye, New York strip, and sirloin steaks. Also cod filet dinners, Alaskan pollock. deep-fried shrimp, roasted catfish and blazing redfish dinners, pork chops, ham steak, beef and seafood combination platters, even beer or wine with your meal. Come see what you're missing at Zock's Family Restaurant. Something good for everyone on 231 South Edge of Crawfordsville.
Right now at Wills Fargo RV Sales and Service, 1993 Jayco travel trailers are coming and going. Many are going out as fast as they come in, and I'm talking about new 93 fifth wheels, travel trailers, fold downs, everything in the RV line is available at Wills Fargo. But they do have a pretty good selection on hand as well, including some cargo trailers, utility trailers, auto carriers, and Wills Fargo is your place to find pickup caps, covers, and toppers. See them all at Wills Fargo, 1 mile east of the junction of 41 and 136 near Vetersburg.
Well, back once again at Wisconsin Fieldhouse. Before we go any further, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
You're listening to 1550 AM WCBL and 103.9 FM WIMC Crawfordsville.
Well, Max, as has been the case throughout this season, when Indiana's faced a team that likes the full-court press, they usually cut it up, and they're doing so this afternoon.
They really are, and they got a great start against Wisconsin doing that. You were talking about three-point play. I was looking at the Big Ten stats before our last Thursday's game. Wisconsin, before that game, had put up 332 three-point shots. That is 96 more than Indiana, which is the second team. They'd only put up 236. So Wisconsin really likes to put up a lot of three-point shots. Their percentage is not that good, just 35%. But today it's 5 of 10 on three-point shots, Indiana 5 of 11. Hoosiers now hitting 59% for the game. Wisconsin has now dropped down to 38%. They've hit only 3 of their last 11 shots.
You talk about a three-point usage. Indiana's doing it as prolifically as any team in the country right now, hitting 43% in Big Ten play. And in recent ball games, it's got to be higher than that. Across the timeline, backcourt dribble, Tracy Webster with Wisconsin. He drives on Chris Reynolds, pulls it back out, looks, fires it inside all by himself as Lewis Eli. Eli had nobody even close to him. He's got his fourth point. Full court pressure. Here's Todd Leary trying to break it, and somebody tripped him. I believe Finley. And Leary went sprawling, and he will get a chance to go, I believe, to the free throw line as the 1-1. No, it is not in effect yet, apparently. That's the 16th foul against Wisconsin. So the Hoosiers have it out of bounds. Wisconsin drops back to set up their half-court defense. And Indiana's Greg Graham will cross the timeline with the ball. Graham starts it to the left on the dribble. Looks in, gets it to Todd Leary. Leary turns, clears to Calvert. Cheney back out to Leary and threw it away. Here's Webster on the steal, takes it down low, and slammed into Reynolds, almost threw it away, no call. Here's the throw away, and Calvert Cheney gets it right back for IU. Here is Chris Reynolds. Reynolds, backcourt, slides it right, gives to Greg Graham. Graham across the free throw lane, clears it back out to Chris. Reynolds now in the paint, gives it back out to Calvert. Cheney drives in, fires it up, off the glass and in. Calvert Cheney's got 9, and the Hoosiers are up 46-31. Here is Finley the other way, and Finley lost the handle out of bounds. Boy, the crowd is really on it. They thought that Finley was fouled, as Pat Knight now will check in for IU with a minute 34 to go in this first half of play. Knight will check in for Todd Leary. Finley will inbound. Finley looks, gets it in to Webster. Tracy Webster drives in the lane, fakes, tried to throw it inside to Eli, and Indiana bats it out of bounds again.
Indiana's doing a good job getting the passing lanes underneath.
And it'll be Harrell inbounding the ball. He gets it backcourt to Johnson for a long three try. Way short, and the rebound comes off the Reynolds. Up court pass to Greg Graham. Graham inside, fries it up, and he is fouled. He had no chance. They hit him right in the small of the back that time, and Greg Graham couldn't get any leg strength to leap that for the layup. So he'll go to the stripe with a pair coming. Greg Graham having another sensational start to this ball game, as he has so often recently. He had 32 in the last outing against Michigan State. He's got 15 already here in the first half today. Stu Jackson over there jawing with Tom Rucker, one of the officials. Jackson said something, Rucker said something else, and now we're ready to go.
Greg Graham will be the man at the line. Graham fires it up, and it is good. Greg Graham now has his 16th point of the contest. He'll have an opportunity for one more. He's hitting 85% of his free throws, and now he has hit two in this ball game. He's got 17. Indiana with its biggest lead at 48-31, 17 points. Backcourt pass Harrell. Bounce pass left to Webster. Webster inside to Finley, and a whistle. And we got a foul call against Indiana. Foul call against IU, and that's some derisive cheering I hear going on from the Wisconsin crowd. Andy Kilbride will now check in. Greg Graham was called for that last foul. That'll be Greg's first of the ball game. Inbound pass, almost thrown away again. Webster comes up with it to Kilbride, right to Finley. Finley drives it in the lane, fires it up, and short. Rebound inside, and a foul on Lewis Eli. Over the back of Pat Knight. So Eli gets nailed on his first foul. They'll go to the other end, and Pat Knight will go to the stripe with a one-on-one opportunity. Well, Pat Knight has hit 2 of 7 from the free throw line this year. He has struggled in that area.
He just 1 of 4 in Big Ten play.
105 left in the half. The Hoosiers are up 17 with Patrick trying to add to that lead. The first is in the air, and a bounce around, and it drops in. Patrick Knight with his first point of the ball game. He'll have one more shot coming. Averaging just under a point a ball game. Pat Ice for number 2. Up it goes, and he drills it. Pat Knight's first 2 of the contest. The Hoosiers now lead at 19, 50-31. 1 minute to go on the half. Tracy Webster across the timeline. Webster in backcourt, slides it right side. On the wing, still moving with it, gives it to Kilbride. Kilbride, back right to Finley. Finley now holds. He looks inside, gives it out to Damon Harrell, bounces to Kilbride. Kilbride looks underneath, fakes, then drives. Tried to pass it inside, and Greg Graham bats it out of bounds. So it'll belong to Wisconsin with 37.8 seconds to go in the half and 18 of the shot clock.
Even when Indiana doesn't get the ball, they disrupt the Wisconsin offense.
Finley will inbound. Michael Finley looks, finally gets it into Tracy Webster. Webster outside to Finley. Finley goes left to Kilbride. He fakes, he drives, jumps it back outside, almost thrown away. Webster up with it. Shot clock down to 7. Webster top of the key, drives it in the lane, fires it up, and missed it. The rebound, Calvert Cheney. Calvert takes it out of trouble to Chris Reynolds. IU will get the last shot of the half. 15 seconds to go. Indiana by 19. Here is Chris Reynolds sliding it toward the right. Down to the corner to Greg Graham. He lets a long one bomb. Go, and he got it. And the crowd was counting it down and had an early count. And that's the end of the first half of play. They thought Graham had taken the shot with way too much time left. And, yeah, he may have, but he hit it. A huge 3 for Graham. And Calvert Cheney comes out and gives him a big hug as they go to the locker room at the break. The score is Indiana 53, Wisconsin 31. Greg Graham drills his 20th point of the first half on that 4th three-point field goal that he has scored in the first 20 minutes. How about that, fans? 53-31 at the half. We'll be back after the 60-second network timeout.
Thousands of years ago, the Chinese mastered the art of abacus. Adding, subtracting, multiplying, dividing. It was all so simple. Not so anymore. Appreciation, depreciation, computers, ever-changing tax and business issues. Put a CPA on your team. Today's certified public accountants are masters in the art and science of maximizing the potential of your money and improving profits. Contact a CPA in your area or the Indiana CPA Society. CPAs make a difference.
Listen carefully. Hear anything wrong? Of course not. You see, the parts in this engine are Napa brand, backed by Napa's National Warranty Program. So if you bought a part in Boston and it didn't work in California, you could return it to one of the 6,700 Napa stores coast to coast. But don't worry, nothing ever goes wrong when you have a warranty. Napa, because there are no unimportant parts.
The
back once again at Wisconsin Fieldhouse, where Indiana is a 53-31 winner. Or 53-31 leader at the halftime. And our score, Indiana by 22 points, starting to totally pull away from the Badgers at the end of that first half of action. Let's take a look now as this Indiana ball club dominates half number one here. The individual scoring, first of all, for Wisconsin, Tracy Webster had 2 3-point field goals, 6 first-half points, 1 personal foul. Andy Kilbride had 3 3-point field goals. He had 9 first-half points and 1 foul. Damon Harrell, a pair of free throws for 2 points and no fouls. Michael Finley with 3 field goals, 2 free throws, 8 first-half points. He has no fouls. Brian Kelly did not score a point in the first half. He picked up 2 personals. Lewis Eli had 2 field goals, 4 points, and 1 personal foul. And Jeff Peterson with a field goal for 2 points and no personals. Jason Johnson played, did not score or foul. Likewise, Adam Carl for Wisconsin. So the top scorer for the Badgers in the first half was Andy Kilbride with 9 and Michael Finley with 8. For Indiana, Chris Reynolds had one free throw for 1 point and no fouls. Damon Bailey had 3 field goals, 1 of them a 3-pointer, 7 first-half points and 1 foul. Mandover, 4 field goals for 8 points in the first half, no fouls. They took 1 field goal we had as a tip-in for Matt and gave it to Greg Graham, so his total is much higher than we initially thought as well. Calvert Cheney had 2 three-point, my apology. He had 3 regular field goals, 1 3-point field goal, 9 first-half points, and no fouls. Greg Graham fired home 4 3-point field goals to go along with 3 4-regular field goals and 2 free throws. 22 points for Greg Graham in the first half of this ball game. Brian Evans had a field goal for 2 points and 2 fouls. Pat Graham with no points and 2 fouls. Todd Leary with a field goal for 2 points, no fouls. And Pat Knight with 2 free throws for 2 points and no personal fouls. So Indiana's being led at the break by Greg Graham with another phenomenal first half. 22 points this afternoon. Calvert Cheney's got 9 for second place in the Hoosier scoring. Max, look at those team stats.
Well, Greg Graham is having a great afternoon. 8 of 12 from the field. He is 4 of 5 from three-point range. So he is doing it all here this afternoon. Indiana is shooting 21 of 34. That's 62%. They're 6 of 12 now for 50% from three-point range and 5 of 6 from the foul line, 83%. Wisconsin is 11 for 30, just 37%. 5 of 11 from three-point range, 45%. They're 4 of 6 from the foul line. Rebounding, Indiana has taken off like gangbusters rebounding. After being about even through most of the first half, it's now 21 to 12 in favor of Indiana rebounding. Turnovers, 5 against Wisconsin and just 3 against Indiana. Cheney is hitting 4 out of 6 in that first half. Nover is 4 for 4. Bailey is 3 for 4. Chris Reynolds had his only shot missed. Todd Leary, 1 of 2. Pat Graham is 0 for 2. And Brian Evans is 1 for 3. Michael Finley, who is such a great player for Wisconsin, has been held to 3 for 11 shooting in that first half. Tracy Webster is 2 for 6. Andy Kilbride is the one bright star percentage-wise, hitting on 3 of 4, all 4 shots being 3-point shots. Indiana outscored Wisconsin 17-4 in the last 5 minutes to have this lead at halftime, 53-31.
All right, Max, we'll be back with our halftime guest, Bob Hamill, right after we pause for the 60-second break. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Some home equity credit makes people uneasy, but not Equity Reserve at National City Bank. Equity Reserve is a no-nonsense, variable-rate credit line for fiscally responsible people who use common sense and good judgment. Right now at National City Bank, you can receive 7.75 APR and no closing cost. Appraisal fee may be assessed. So stop by a nearby National City Banking office to apply for your Equity Reserve credit line. Then relax. National City Bank, going the distance for you at all Montgomery County locations and equal housing lender.
See the grain drill built for all field conditions, no-till included. The John Deere 750, now at Jackson Lee Pearson in Frankfort. Use the 750 drill for any conservation seeding or any conventional seeding. Excellent accuracy and depth control. It's available in 10 or 15 foot working widths or 30 feet with a 2-unit hitch. See the John Deere 750 drill today at Jackson Lee Pearson on State Road 28 in Frankfort. We're working hard to earn your business.
Well, the Indiana Hoosiers lead the Wisconsin Badgers here at halftime by a score of 53-31 as we've got spectators shooting now on some kind of a game they got going on down there. We've got Bob Hamill alongside. Bob, Indiana's playing some pretty good basketball the last couple of weeks, and today is no exception.
I think it really responded to that loss at Ohio State. Greg Graham just may have been the best player in a very good league the last 5 or 6 ball games.
I thought coming into this game, if there was ever a situation in which Wisconsin would want to catch Indiana, if you have to play them at all, today might be the best day. Having won the Big Ten, really not a lot at stake out here, but it doesn't seem to make any difference.
Well, I think that's true. It is a kind of a challenge. I think it's a pride game for them. They're the champions, and they want to play like champions, and to their credit, they certainly have to this point.
And of course, much of this just has to go to Coach Knight, who always has his team ready to play.
Well, you know, Bob went through that very same experience. In his senior year, they came to Wisconsin with a Big Ten championship clinched at Ohio State, had a 12-0 league record and lost. And I think that was one he could play on a little bit. I think he understood exactly how a team could approach it. And because the priority... as of Wednesday night, winning, the priority does become the NCAA tournament. I don't think there's any question about that. But this has been a really high-quality performance today.
Well, Bob, we're going to come back. I want to talk to you a little bit about the NCAA and your thoughts of what we're going to be seeing in just a few hours from now. But right now, let's pause 60 seconds. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
What can you buy that still works like new 20 years later? A Puritan water conditioning unit. It's true. Puritan water conditioners are built to last and last and last. Puritan's success can be attributed to making the best in water conditioning equipment, selecting the proper unit for your individual needs, and keeping their customers happy with prompt, reliable service. Invest in a Puritan water conditioner today. Phone 362-6340 for a free water analysis or stop in at 216 Lafayette Avenue in Crawfordsville.
Do yourself a flavor when you stop in at the Duck Inn Diner. Taste the homemade food in an authentic 50s-era real stainless steel diner. Treat yourself to real home cooking and the finest pie and coffee around. Everyone knows the Duck Inn Diner has the finest meals you can find, but don't forget the award-winning desserts at the Duck Inn Diner.
So make the day special, make it fabulous. Do yourself a flavor. Come dine with us.
Stop in at the Duck Inn Diner today at the corner of US 52 and State Road 28.
53-31, we're talking with Bob Hamill, the sports editor of the Herald Times, the Bloomington paper. Bob covering Indiana of August all the way. Bob, of course, now we're ready for the pairings to be announced. It looks as if Indiana should get that number one seed, and maybe that's good, maybe that's bad.
Oh, I think it's very good. I think that'll happen. Whatever happened today, I think it was going to happen. I think they surely nailed that down by winning the Big Ten outright in a year when I think the whole nation respected the Big Ten. I think the one value of it is being able to stay at home, play at Indianapolis, and I'm presuming that will be the case. You never know when the committee gets a session, but I'm guessing that would be the route, and certainly the Indianapolis people love this basketball team, so I think it would be a great shot for them to get started there.
It'd be a mutiny if they sent them to Chicago, wouldn't it?
Well, they could do that, I guess, that isn't exactly enemy territory.
That's right. But a lot of big tickets have been sold thinking they're going to Indianapolis. Bob, you had a very interesting column this morning before I left Bloomington. I read the fact that the number one seeds, first of all, I guess there's never been two number one seeds in the Big Ten. There's a good chance of that happening this year.
Yeah, never two from the Big Ten and no two from the same conference for 8 years. It's kind of, I hadn't thought of it until I put the numbers down. But it is kind of unusual. They've only been seeding since 79, so that's been, this is the 15th year of it. But there have only been three conferences that did it. SEC once, the ACC once, and Big Eight once.
Big Ten has a good chance this year with Michigan.
I just don't see how it can avoid it. I think I think Michigan definitely will get a number one and should. And I would guess they would be assigned to the West. That looks like the likely thing.
The other thing, your column pointed out that number one seeds haven't always been successful.
Well, it is kind of funny. That is the, in effect, the NCAA's guesses at who would make up the Final Four. So they pick their four, what they think are the four best teams, and by putting them in regionals, give them the chance to go that far. And their batting average isn't very good for that purpose. I think they've averaged going to the final game of the regionals, so it's not all that bad, but some have lost considerably earlier than that.
What are your picks for the top eight teams of number ones and number two seeds?
Well, I think, everybody's saying North Carolina will get the East. I'm wondering about that since Seton Hall cannot go to the East. And the only reason I bring Seton Hall into that is that North Carolina and Duke aren't going to be sent to the same place. I think Duke will get a two. So I'm wondering if they might not send North Carolina and Seton Hall to the Southeast and Kentucky and Duke to the East, which is at the Meadowlands, and that's the reason that Seton Hall can't go that way. Indiana, Kansas in the Midwest, and Michigan, Arizona in the West. I think some combination of that will be there. It's possible that because of Seton Hall's situation, that Seton Hall could end up in the Midwest as a number two seed.
One final question. It looks as if Indiana, the state of Indiana, is going to be pretty well represented in this NCAA.
Yeah, it's really, really great what the Ball State was able to do. I think those of us who knew Joby Wright and Bob Donawal were really, really happy for them and the seasons they had, too, in their MAC. And then Jimmy Cruz's win with Evansville was a great, great thing for him and a great win. I think probably Jimmy's league will end up with two in there. I don't know whether Joby can get in as a co-champion of the MAC in the regular season, but he had a great, great year.
Bob, I appreciate your coming by and visiting with us here at halftime. We got 20 more minutes, and we'll see what happens then.
Thank you, Matt.
Bob Hamill visiting with us here at halftime. Indiana leads the Wisconsin Badgers at halftime, 53-31. Indiana in that first half shot 21 of 34. That's 61% in the first half. Excellent shooting. They were 6 of 12 from three-point range, 50% from the free throw line. They were 5 of 6, 83%. For Wisconsin, they finished hitting on 11 of 30, 36.7%. They were 5 of 11 from three-point range, 45.5, and they were 4 of 6 from the foul line. And the rebounding, as we mentioned to you, 21-12, Indiana holding a commanding rebound lead.
Well, the Hoosier Ball Club is conducting another clinic here in the first half of this ball game this afternoon. Let's see if they can maintain that. Sometimes that's very difficult to do when you're leading by 22 at the break. We'll be back to start the second half of this ball game right after we pause for the 60-second network timeout.
The Hoosier Lottery reminds basketball fans that you have to play to win.
Well, with 2 seconds left, the All-Stars are going to have to give the ball to star shooter Swish Sampson. Dave the Dribbler, Nelson inbounds, looking for Swish, but where is he? Oh, no, the Swishers on the sideline signing autographs. The All-Stars lose a heartbreaker, all because of a 7-foot ego trip.
Get in the game and win. Play the Hoosier Lottery.
Play the Hoosier Lottery's newest instant game. Crash the boards and pull down $1,000 instantly. There are 3 chances to win in this basketball game. From the Hoosier Lottery.
Let's talk electricity. I have a few words. Indiana's consumer-owned rural electric cooperatives. Quite a mouthful, huh? Well, maybe our name's so long because we do so much. Like providing reliable electric service to over 1 million people across the state. Or investing over $2 billion into bringing you the electricity that offers you necessities like lights, refrigerators, washers and dryers, and much more. Indiana's rural electric cooperatives. But you don't need to call us by name. Just know we'll be there whenever you need us.
Here at Wisconsin Fieldhouse, about to get the second half of basketball underway. Well, D-Dance Gentlemen's and Ladies Clothier of Indianapolis want to join the thousands of Hoosier fans all across the state in congratulating Indiana University's basketball team on winning the Big Ten Championship and, of course, wishing them all the best in their quest for the 1993 NCAA Championship. D-Dance is open daily Monday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. and on Wednesday and Thursday they're open till 9. D-Dance Clothing to complement your lifestyle on West 86th Street at Township Line Road in the North Fuller Mall in Indianapolis. We are ready to start the second half with Chris Reynolds, Damon Bailey, Greg Graham, Calvert Cheney, and Matt Dover on the floor for IU. Kilbride, Finley, Harrell, Webster, and Eli on the floor for Wisconsin.
Here's the pass outside. Wisconsin with the ball. Tracy Webster with it in backcourt. Webster bounces it left to Michael Finley. He goes to Kilbride. Ball batted away, knocked out of bounds, and it belonged to Wisconsin. Good defensive play again by Reynolds. So it'll be Wisconsin's ball underneath their own hoop. Reynolds has been a tremendous defensive player in this ball game, as he almost always is. Here's the inbound. This one comes to Kilbride. Back out to Webster. Webster on the dribble. Fires it away to Michael Finley. Finley moves against Graham. Stops. Clears to Webster. Webster comes back outside against Greg Graham now. Now the pass left to Kilbride. Kilbride swings back out to Finley, or Eli rather. Now to Webster. Down low to Harrell. He works on Nover. Puts it up. Block shot by Matt Nover. Out of bounds. It'll belong to Wisconsin. Only 6 seconds remain on the shot clock. Another good defensive play by Indiana. The Badgers will inbound. It'll be Damon Harrell who'll trigger the pass in. Harrell looks, fires it in. It comes to Webster for a three try. No good. Short and a rebound batted away. And Nover tips it off to Damon Bailey. Now to Reynolds across the timeline. Chris in backcourt goes to Greg Graham. Down low to Calvert. All by himself from 17. No good. Rebound pulled out of there by Webster. Back down the floor. Great defensive effort by Chris Reynolds, and the ball deflects into Stu Jackson's head. Out of bounds to the Badgers. So Indiana again playing some solid defense here. Michael Finley will trigger the inbound for the Badgers. He gets it into Kilbride. Kilbride slides it left, bounces it low to Finley. Finley works on Graham, back to Kilbride for a three try, and it's good. Andy Kilbride has just hit his fourth three of the afternoon. And it's 53-34, Indiana by 19. Greg Graham for the Hoosiers. Backcourt to Chris Reynolds. Left side to Damon Bailey. Bailey flies an 18-footer. In and out, no, and the rebound comes off to Eli. Eli for Wisconsin. Back the other way. Eli across the timeline to Finley. Finley now clears out backcourt to Tracy Webster, to Kilbride on the right side. Down low it goes to Eli. He looks, flips it away to Harrell. Harrell gives it to Finley. Finley working, drives it right side, and the whistle. We got a travel or a foul. It'll be a foul on Damon Bailey. Bailey picks up personal number two, and it'll be Wisconsin's ball out of bounds. This one into Kilbride, drives it left side, stops, back out to Webster. Webster goes right. He fires a 15-footer and hit it. Tracy Webster buries his first two of the second half. He's got eight now for the ball game, and suddenly the Badgers have drilled five in a row. Here is Calvert Chaney answering the call. Chaney hits his 11th point on about a 16-foot jump shot, and it's 55-36. IU on top by 19. Finley with the basketball for the Badgers. Now to Webster. Down low to Eli, or Harrell rather. Turnaround jump shot's no good, and Chris Reynolds comes away with a loose ball. Down the floor, Reynolds. Right side to Calvert. Down to the corner to Graham. Greg fires a three. He missed it. Rebound pulled out of there by Eli. Back the other way. Eli to Kilbride. Kilbride outside to Finley. Finley now, the spin dribble. Fires it up from 10 and a scoop and got the roll. Michael Finley's 10th point. 55-38. Badgers slowly getting back into it again. Here is Bailey. Baseline move and a whistle. We got a foul called against Wisconsin. Damon tried to drive the baseline and somebody hung on. Webster was called for the foul. That's his second. Harrell goes out of the lineup. Brian Kelly comes in for Wisconsin. Indiana will have the ball underneath their own basket. The lob into Calvert. Chaney in the lane. Fires it up and couldn't get the roll. Rebound batted away to Nover. Back up, no. Whistle and a foul call against Brian Kelly. Kelly will be nailed on this one. That'll be Kelly's third foul of this contest. And Matt Nover, I believe, is going to go to the line. And coming in for the Badgers for the first time, I think we are, let's see who it is. It is Otto McDuffie, a 6'5 freshman out of Milwaukee, Wisconsin, who hasn't seen a lot of playing time this year. So McDuffie is in. He replaces Finley. And they're going to send in another a new face, Jeff Peterson, as Matt Nover fires the free throw good. Matt Nover has his 9th point of the contest. He'll have one more shot coming.
Matt also has 9 rebounds in this game.
He is playing well. Kelly checks out. Peterson comes in for the Badgers. Matt Nover with one more shot. looking for his 10th point. And it bounces through. He's got his 10th of the ball game, and Indiana's on top by 19 at 57-38. Across the timeline, Webster to Peterson. He goes left side to McDuffie. McDuffie back out top of the key to Kilbride. Kilbride slides it to the left wing, looks inside, then fires a three. Missed it this time. Rebound. Calvert has it for IU. Cheney clears it out to Reynolds. Reynolds quickly across the timeline. Lost the handle, got it back. Chris gives it off to Damon. Damon drives in the lane. He scoops it inside to Nover. It's knocked out of bounds. It'll belong to IU. So the Hoosiers will have it underneath the Indiana basket. Damon Bailey will trigger the inbounds pass. Bailey gets it to Calvert. Jump pass into Nover. Puts it up. It's batted away. A good block shot by Wisconsin. Here is Webster the other way. Webster crosses over to McDuffie, who lost the handle. Matt Nover clears it out of there to Greg Graham. Here come the Hoosiers again. Reynolds, top of the key. Inside to Damon. Fakes, puts it up. No. Block shot again. Here's Eli the other way. Off to Kilbride, right wing. He holds, clears out to Webster. Webster drives it in. Pitches it out to Kilbride. He crosses the key, then fires it up. Missed the shot, but a blocking foul. Calvert Cheney will get nailed on this one. That'll be his first foul of this contest. 57-38, 16-12 on the clock. Indiana on top by 19, but a chance for Andy Kilbride, who has 12 points in this ball game, to cut that lead down. And Max, he's about to match his career high with his first free one if he drops it through.
He's shot nothing but three-point shots today, and he's hit 4 out of 6.
And he fires that one home. Kilbride has 13 now. Well, I shouldn't have said that. He is actually a career high as 15. He's got 13. He can come within one if he hits the second one. And he does. He's got 14. And Indiana's lead down to 17 at 57-40. Here's Chris Reynolds the other way in a hurry. Off to Damon. Lays it up and scores and a foul. It'll be on Lewis Eli, who tried to set up the charge, but he wasn't ready and didn't have himself set long enough. And Bailey's got his 9th point and a chance for a 3-point play for IU. If he connects, Hugh will pull Indiana out to a 20-point lead again. So Damon Bailey goes to the line. Bailey hitting 75% in Big Ten play of his free throws, 73% for the season. Pumps this one in the air, and he got it. Damon's got 10, and the Hoosiers are on top by 20, 60-40. Across the timeline, Webster to Peterson. Left side to McDuffie. McDuffie outside to Kilbride. Kilbride holds, top of the key, down low it goes to Eli. Turnaround jump shot short. Rebound batted away. Knocked away to Kilbride. He comes up with it. Kilbride gives it back out to Webster. Webster inside to Eli, who puts it up and in. Eli gets his 6th point. Full court pressure by Wisconsin. Indiana up 60-42. Damon Bailey will break the press. Crosses the timeline to Reynolds. Chris jumps it across to Calvert Cheney, who fakes. Calvert now baseline move. Cups up inside. Puts it up. No whistle. We got a foul call. The Badger fans don't like the call much, but Calvert will go to the stripe for a pair. Cheney drove the baseline and made about 3 different moves inside there, Max, trying to get a shot off and never really did.
I was trying to decide what he was going to do with it. He got himself under there, and I wasn't quite sure what he was going to do. He ended up trying to get a shot away.
Now into the ball game. A couple of new faces. Michael Finley back in there. And also in for the first time is Grant Johnson, a 7-foot, 244-pound junior out of Plymouth, Minnesota. Eli sits down as Cheney goes to the line with 11 points. Calvert eyes his attempt, and this one drops in. He's got his 12th point of the ball game now. He'll have an opportunity for one more. Cheney hitting 81% of his Big Ten free throws, 79% totally for the year. Averaging 21-9 a ball game. His second shot also good, and Calvert Cheney's got 13. We got a timeout. Indiana 62, Wisconsin 42. 15:27 left. Back after the 60-second network break.
Hear that?
Wow, it even sounds warm. Is it because my ears are big?
No, it's because I chose Gas Heat, Dumbo.
Today's natural gas heating technology means comfort and savings. It's the ideal energy for your home.
When my shower ran out of hot water, I had this little trick to keep me warm. I used to sing.
Well, I mean, it's safer than dancing, isn't it? Okay, prettier too.
Natural gas technology means more hot water for less. It's the ideal energy for your family.
Oh, nice apron. Love the ruffles.
Oh, thanks. But you know, cooking with natural gas is a breeze with pilotless ignition and sealed burners. I'll cook dinner for once.
Oh, no, dear. You'll cook dinner for one.
Natural gas is what's new in today's kitchens. It's the ideal energy for cooking. For new information on today's natural gas technology and the ideal energy, call Indiana Gas at 1-800-777-4414.
Before we go any further, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network. Well, Indiana right now is a 20-point lead over Wisconsin with 15:27 to go in this final half of play.
Indiana's off to a very poor shooting starting the second half. They've hit only 2 out of 8 shots here in the second half. Wisconsin 4 of 9 for the game now. Indiana 55%, Wisconsin 38%. Wisconsin rebounding even with Indiana here in the second half, but it's a 25-19 advantage for Indiana for the entire game. Right now, Greg Graham has missed his only shot. Cheney's only hit 1 out of 3 here in this second half of play. Damon Bailey's hit just 1 out of 3. So Indiana having a hard time getting started, but nevertheless, they have a 20-point lead, which is only 2 down from what they had at halftime.
Well, the Hoosiers back out of the floor with Cheney, Graham, that's Greg, Damon Bailey, Chris Reynolds, and Matt Nover. News this week that Calvert Cheney, in addition to becoming the all-time career Big Ten scoring leader, was named Basketball Player of the Year in the college ranks by Sports Illustrated, the Sporting News, and Basketball Weekly, and also named to the United States Basketball Writers Association All-American team. So Cheney is reaping the rewards of a great season and a great career at Indiana. Here come the Badgers, now down 20. Tracy Webster across the timeline, bats past to Andy Kilbride. Kilbride outside to Johnson, Grant Johnson we're talking of. Now out to Kilbride again. Kilbride stops, looks, fires left to Michael Finley. Down inside, pass goes to Webster. He drives in the lane, pulls it back out to Finley, now to Kilbride. Kilbride moves on Bailey, slides it out to Peterson. He drives it right, pumps a 12-footer and hit it. Jeff Peterson's got his 4th point. 62-44. Chris Reynolds to Bailey, takes it inside, puts it off to Calvert. The ball batted out of bounds, saved by Peterson, knocked out of bounds again, and this time it'll belong to the Badgers. That was a heck of a play by Peterson, who bounced it between his legs to save it from going out of bounds. Badgers down 18. Stu Jackson wants to pick up the tempo here. Here's Tracy Webster driving in left side, takes it to the wing, inside to Peterson, up and in. Peterson left alone again. He's got 6. And the Hoosiers suddenly have broken down to a 16-point lead. Here's Chris Reynolds. Stops, trying to pass it to Calvert. Threw it out of bounds. Well, if Murphy's Law goes into effect, it has gone into effect in a big way suddenly. That's the 5th Indiana turnover in the second straight. 14:20 on the clock. Here's Webster bringing it up the floor. Webster slides it to the right side, pulls it back out, still in the dribble, lobs it into Grant Johnson. Johnson now works on Nover, forces it up, and got it. Grant Johnson gets his first 2. Here's Damon Bailey outside to Chris Reynolds, back to Bailey. Bailey trying to get it across the timeline, does. Damon takes it in the lane, pulls it out of there, gives to Chris Reynolds, now out to Greg Graham. Again to Chris, and Indiana sets the offense as Bailey works it on the left wing. Damon to Calvert. Cheney, he drives it right, pulls up, fires, and hits it a foul. Calvert Cheney guns home his 15th point of the ball game and will go to the line for a chance at a 3-point play. That's a big bucket there, Max, because number one, he quiets the crowd, and number two, maybe gets him a little confidence back. He looked like he was wavering somewhere.
Indiana had been outscored 10-2 just before that basket. They were starting to hurt a bit.
Calvert at the line looking for a 3-point play the old-fashioned way. He fires and got it. 16 now for Calvert Cheney, and the Hoosiers are on top 65-48. Lead is back up to 17.
In the backcourt dribble, this is Tracy Webster for the Badgers, harassed out there by Reynolds. Now Webster clears it to Kilbride, top of the key. Kilbride against Bailey. Slides it left, pulls up, swings it back out to Webster. Webster drives it right out to Finley. Finley turns, spins, fires, and missed it, but a foul. Chris Reynolds will be nail at it. That'll be Reynolds' first foul of this ball game. Well, you got to admire his tenacity. Reynolds is so quick, and he has harassed everybody he has guarded this afternoon, especially Tracy Webster, to a point of frustration.
He had only one steal in the first half, but he must have broken up another three or four plays in that first half.
So Finley goes to the free throw line. Michael Finley with 10 points in this ball game, looking with two shots here at the stripe and drilling his first. He's got 11. Finley's another guy who finds some way to put it in the hole. He's a scorer. And it's 65-49 as he tries to cut that lead down to 15 with his second attempt. 13-15 on the clock in this ball game. The second toss also good. Michael Finley now with 12. Inbound pass comes to Greg Graham. Graham gets it to Chris Reynolds. Up court throw away, but Webster can't save it from going out of bounds. It'll belong to IU. Bob Knight looks down his bench. He'll pull Todd Leary back in the ball game. Leary is going to check in for Indiana. And Chris Reynolds will sit out for a rest. Reynolds to the sideline. Calvert Cheney will trigger the inbound. He gets it into Todd Leary. Leary now in backcourt. Leary slides it toward the left. Can't find Bailey. Does find Cheney. He pumps it up, and he got it. Calvert Cheney's got his 18th point. His hand starts to heat up, and it's 67-50. IU by 17 again. Peterson in backcourt, holds on, looks for help, clears it away to Finley. Finley drives it left against Damon Bailey, clears it away to Kilbride in backcourt, again to Finley. Finley this time right to Tracy Webster. Webster on the wing, guarded by Bailey, lobs it low to Peterson, who turns, fires it up, missed the shot, and Calvert Cheney's got the rebound. Bounces it out of trouble to Bailey. Damon down the floor to Greg Graham. Graham in the corner to Leary. Three on the way. No good. Rebound, Matt Nover. Knocked away from him. Out of bounds. It belongs to Wisconsin. And Bob Knight says, no way. That was knocked out by a Badger player. But the Wisconsin Ball Club has it anyway. Across the timeline, Tracy Webster on the walk. Webster got it by Leary now. Webster toward the right side. Still in the dribble. Webster now holds, looks for help, turns around, having trouble, finally bounces it out of trouble to Peterson. Now back to Webster. Webster again directs some traffic out there, bounces to Kilbride. He takes it up inside and got it. And a foul. Andy Kilbride's having himself a day. He just got a new career high with his 16th point. And the sophomore of Kankakee, Illinois, will have a chance at his 17th here. Pat Graham, who has been on the bench the entire second half, is going to check in for IU, and Brian Kelly will be back in for the Badgers as Jeff Peterson sits down.
Pat Graham didn't play a lot in that first half, only 3 minutes. He's been playing a bit more of that these past few games.
And here comes Brian Evans into the ballgame now for the Hoosiers. He's going to replace Matt Nover, give him a rest. Nover leaves with 10 points, a bunch of rebounds, and at the stripe, Kilbride for the Badgers. Kilbride fires it up and got it. He's got 17. The lead's down to 14 again. And we got a timeout with 11:56 to go. It's Indiana 67, Wisconsin 53. We'll be back after the 60-second network timeout.
Say, neighbors, that one of those new snapper lawn tractors I see in your garage?
You betcha. This baby is built tough. And talk about power. A Briggs IC with 12 horses, Peerless 5-speed gear drive, 30-inch cutting deck with 6 cutting heights, 32-inch turning radius, 2-year limited warranty.
Boy, you must have run into some cash to buy this snapper tractor a couple of months before the grass needs to be cut.
Oh, not at all. I just use Snap Credit, so I don't have to start paying for it until October. Besides, with Snapper tractors starting at $14.99, these babies aren't going to last very long down at the Snapper dealer.
You know, neighbor, I think I'll go visit that Snapper dealer before the spring rush starts.
This is the sound of the most dreaded vehicle on the road today, the tow truck. Because when you hear it, you know it's going to cost you. So don't cut corners. Get the best parts money can buy. NAPA. Parts built to meet or exceed original standards. And avoid the tow truck. NAPA. Because there are no unimportant parts.
Well, Bob,
Wisconsin Fieldhouse, where Indiana right now is leading Wisconsin 67-53. We have 11:56 to go in this ballgame, and despite the fact that this Hoosier ball club has dominated through much of this ballgame, right now the Badgers have an opportunity, Max, to get back in it.
Well, they do, and Indiana's not hitting is the problem. It hit only 4 of 11 this half. That's just 27%. You're going to fall back all the time if you're hit only that kind of a percentage. Wisconsin's right now hitting 8 of 14. Of course, that's better than they've normally been hitting. They're up to now 43% for the game. Indiana has dropped down to 56% for the game.
Brian Evans, Greg Graham, Pat Graham, Todd Leary, and Calvert Cheney now the lineup on the floor for Indiana. So we have three starters on the bench, Nover, Bailey, and Reynolds. Bob Knight's a little bit concerned right now with how his ball club is handling the basketball.
They've turned it over only five times, just two times here in the half, but they both did it two in a row, as you mentioned a moment ago, and it's given Wisconsin the opportunity to pick up some space here.
Indiana continues shooting it pretty well, 55% for the ballgame. Out of the floor for the Badgers now, Tracy Webster, Finley, Brian Kelly, Andy Kilbride, and Grant Johnson. And they drop off. They're not full court pressing on this possession as Calvert Cheney inbounds to Todd Leary, and Leary will bring it across the timeline. Leary, backcourt dribble against Webster, spins left, comes back right, comes back left again, spins right to Pat Graham. Graham slides it down low to Calvert, and he is fouled. Cheney took it up and slammed it, but Michael Finley was called for a foul out on the floor. So Finley has picked up his first of the ball game. He was hanging on, but Indiana will get it out of bounds. Greg Graham now will inbound it. Graham, who had 22 points in the first half, has not scored a point in this one. The pass comes Evans to Pat Graham, off to Leary, now to Calvert, to Greg Graham. Graham slides it top of the key. Gets it to Pat Graham. He looks low, brings it back right, stops, looks, and threw it away. So the Hoosiers turn it over. And that 14-point lead could dissipate even further. That's the sixth IU turnover in the ballgame. Now, Tracy Webster will cross the timeline. Webster slides it to the right wing. On the dribble. Outside to Kelly. He pumps it up. He missed it. The rebound. Got his own. Back up he goes. Lost the handle. Comes out to Finley. Finley cross courts to Kelly. Now up to Kilbride. Kilbride fakes. Clears it back to Webster. Webster in backcourt to reset the offense. Webster on the dribble toward the right side. Pulls it out to the wing. Back outside to Finley for a three try. Got it. That's a big basket for Wisconsin. 15 points down for Finley, and the lead suddenly evaporates to 11. Todd Leary jumps at the Pat Graham to Greg Graham. Greg in backcourt. Now off to Todd Leary. Right side to Pat Graham. Pat looks inside. Brings it back top of the key. Goes right to Greg Graham. He looks it low. Back on he comes. Stops. Bounces to Pat Graham. Pat down into Calvert. Cheney cross courts out to Brian Evans. Evans takes it outside the Pat Graham again. Now Graham goes to Leary. Leary holds on the wing to Calvert Cheney, top of the key. Calvert back out to Greg Graham, who drives baseline, pulls up, fires, and missed the shot. Rebound inside. Pat Graham had it, knocked away out of bounds. It'll belong to Wisconsin. And suddenly we got a ball game. The Badgers down by 11, have the basketball back. And Leary, Pat Graham, and Brian Evans sit down. Damon Bailey, Matt Nover, and Chris Reynolds come back in. 10:04 to go. Here comes Webster up the floor on the dribble. Walks it up against Reynolds. Now picks up the tempo, crossing the timeline. Drives it to the left side. Still picked up by Reynolds. Into Finley, all alone for a slam dunk. And Michael Finley suddenly has 17. Here's Chris Reynolds, throws it up court. Madden over, comes up with the ball. He clears to Damon Bailey. Bailey bounces to Reynolds. Chris, right side of the circle, comes back off top of the key. Reynolds finds Calvert Cheney in the wing. He drives baseline, spins, turns, fires it up, scores! Calvert Cheney with a huge bucket there. He's got 20. 69-58. IU by 11 again. Finley with a ball left wing out to Kilbride.
Kilbride down low to Kelly. Kelly turns on Cheney. Back out to Kilbride. Kilbride clears to Webster. Webster backs it out of there near the midcourt line. Sets up the offense. Webster started it right. Comes back outside. Got a little one-on-one game here. Webster drives it right. Pulls up. Fires and hits. Webster's got 10. That's 69-60. Graham goes to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds brings it up the court. Jump pass goes to Damon Bailey. Bailey down in the lane. Bounces to Gray Graham for reverse layup. Gray Graham has his 24th point of the day. Nice feed from Bailey. 71-60, IU by 11. Kelly goes to Finley left side. Finley drives it baseline. Pulls up, fires, and missed it. The rebound to Matt Nover inside. Nover now with 10 rebounds. That was a big board there. Here is Reynolds to Calvert in the lane. Fires from 10 and no good. Rebound to Finley for Wisconsin. Back the other way come the Badgers. And here's a steal by Greg Graham from behind. Finley didn't know he was there, and Greg Graham came from behind and stripped it away. Now, here's Chris Reynolds for IU. Great play defensively. Here's Bailey. Damon back out to Chris Reynolds. He goes baseline. Scoop shot is up, no good. And the rebound comes down to Finley again. Back the other way. Kilbride fires a three. Got it. Andy Kilbride with a career-high 20 points, and that's his fifth three of the afternoon. 71-63, Wisconsin, down by just 8 now. Here's the pass to Bailey. This crowd is back into it. Calvert Cheney in the lane, passes it off into Chris Reynolds. Back up he goes. He missed the shot again, and the rebound comes off to Wisconsin's Brian Kelly. Up the floor, pass to Kilbride. Kilbride fires it out to Webster. Webster backcourt will reset the offense. Down to 7:14. Clock running, but Wisconsin getting back into it. They're down just 8. Here is Brian Kelly. Left side pass to Michael Finley. Finley on the baseline move. Pulls up. Fires and scores. Finley has got 19, and the Hoosiers' lead is down to 6. 71-65. Chris Reynolds to Greg Graham on the right side baseline. Back out it comes to Reynolds. Reynolds down. Right side to Graham. Greg holds to Calvert. Cheney drives, pulls up into Nover, slams it in. Matt Nover's 12 point, a nice look by Calvert Cheney. 73-65. Here is Webster with a basketball right and a timeout by Wisconsin. 6:26 to go, and Indiana holds an 8-point lead, but it's not going to be easy the rest of the way, it doesn't appear. We'll be back after the 60-second network timeout.
In the Hoosier State. State Farm is there with a great value for Indiana's young homeowners. Good homeowners protection at a good price. Good neighbor service you can't put a price on. Plus a variety of discounts. That's why Indiana's young families start with and stay with State Farm. From South Bend to Evansville, you can't find a better homeowners insurance value.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Now, Madam Yolanda will read your palm. Oh, you're a farmer. You grow beans.
Soybeans.
I feel a powerful presence. Two strong forces working together to solve all your problems.
Could it be tricept herbicide?
Are your problems broadleaf weeds and grasses?
Yes.
Like pigweeds, foxtails, cockleburr?
Yeah.
Ah, then the answer is tricept, made with Scepter herbicide and Treflan herbicide for the most power you can pack in a jug.
All that's in my palm?
No, in your tricept brochure. Oh, one more thing. See your Cyanamid AgriCenter dealer. Read and follow label directions.
Well, back once again at Wisconsin Fieldhouse in Madison, where the Badgers have fought their way back into this contest. Indiana leads 73-65, 6:26 to go.
Well, Wisconsin has been shooting pretty well in this second half, 62% to be precise on 13 of 21. At the same time, Indiana's hit only 7 out of 18 for just 39%. And as a result, Wisconsin has chopped off 16 points off of, or 14 points right now off of that 22-point lead that Indiana had at halftime. Indiana still continuing to hit well for the game, 54%, but most of that was all built up in the first half.
Wisconsin now 47% for the game. Indiana's hit just two of its last nine shots. Wisconsin's hit five of its last seven shots. Greg Graham, who had 22 points in the first half, has been held to just 2 points. He's taken only two shots here in the second half of play. Cheney, on the other hand, has picked things up as he's hit four out of seven here in the second half.
Well, Indiana sends out Matt Dover, Greg Graham, Chris Reynolds, David Bailey, and Calvert Cheney. The Badgers bowed down by just eight. Have Louis Eli back in there. Adam Carlos checked in. Jeff Peterson is in there. Jason Johnson's in there, and Michael Findler. So Stu Jackson's made a lot of changes here.
He's got some three-point shooters in there.
Well, Tracy Webster's one of those, too, but he's not in there right now. Whole new group in there. Maybe giving the other guys a bit of a rest here and maybe getting him back in shortly. See if they can make a run. Here is Adam Carl driving it toward the left side on the wing. Turns around, clears it out to Jason Johnson. Johnson now on the dribble, slides it in the lane, pitches to Michael Findley. Findley driving, fibers lost the handle, and Indiana comes up with it. Down the floor, this is Greg Graham on the left wing. He'll pull it back outside. The Hoosiers will work some clock. To Bailey, nope, three-pointer. He got it! Damon Bailey bangs home his 13th point of the ball game, a huge three-point bucket there. And the lead's back to 11. Here in backcourt is Carl once again. He drives it right side of the wing. Adam Carl on the dribble, stops, looks, bounces out to Findley. Findley now lobs it inside to Eli. Eli backs it up and puts it in, and a foul is called. Louis Eli gets nailed on the personal. That'll be his, or rather hits the field goal, and the foul is called on Matt Nover. That is his first of the ball game. Well, actually, it's his second. Nover's second personal foul. And to the free throw line is Louis Eli. So Eli with a chance here to knock that lead down again. 9 of 11 for the Badgers from the line today, and he hits another. Big three-point play for Eli. And almost a steal as Greg Graham takes it out of trouble to Nover and back to Graham. Here they come up the floor. Greg Graham now in the lane to Calvert. Puts it up and in. What a move. Cheney's got 22, and Greg Graham with a great assist. Back up to the 10-point lead again. 78-68. 5:16 to go. Jansen. Johnson drives it to the right side to Findley on the baseline. Inside to Jeff Peterson. Turnaround shot. No good. And the rebound comes off to Chris Reynolds. Out of bounds. Reynolds had it come off of his foot. And it'll belong to Wisconsin. Out of bounds. That's the seventh turnover now by Indiana. So Jeff Peterson will trigger the inbounds pass. Indiana with 5:06 left, protecting a 10-point lead here. The pass from Peterson. Having trouble. Finally clears it in. It goes to Findley in backcourt. Findley to the left wing. Outside, though, Tracy Webster, who's checked back in now. Webster backs it out. Starts it left. Drives it to the wing. Goes, fires up a 12-footer. Got it. Tracy Webster scored. That's his 12 point. 78-70. Indiana holding an 8-point advantage. Chris Reynolds with the ball. Right side to Greg Graham. Graham looks low. Brings it back top of the key to Calvert on the left wing. He goes baseline, pulls up, fires, and high off the rim, no. Rebound, Louis Eli for Wisconsin. Now the Badgers have another crack. Here's Findley driving it inside, firing and scoring. Findley's got 21. The lead sinks to 6. 78-72. Here's the pass to Greg Graham. Graham on the wing. Brings it back outside, top of the key. Graham goes right to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds looks, finds Bailey. Damon back out to Chris. Now, Chris goes to Calvert. Down left to Bailey. Bailey a three-pointer on the way. No good. Rebound, Chris Reynolds for IU. He takes it back out of trouble to Cheney. Back to Reynolds. Indiana resets the offense. They're going to work some clock now. 6-point Hoosier lead, 3:40 to go. Here is Reynolds to Greg Graham in backcourt. Graham looks low, finds Calvert. Cheney against Findley. Back outside to Reynolds. Now Reynolds spins, drives it right.
to Calvert Cheney in the lane. Pulls up, passes to Nover, shot up, in, and a foul. Matt Nover scores a big bucket there, his 14th point of the game, and he will go to the line with a chance at a three-point play as Tracy Webster got him. That'll be his third foul of the afternoon on Tracy Webster. The fans thought that Nover traveled.
Indiana's 11 for 12 from the foul line.
So the Hoosiers have shot it well from the stripe today. Nover with 14 points. Tries to make it a 9-point lead, and he does. Nothing but net, 15 now for Nover, and the Hoosiers lead it by 9, 81-72 as the Badger crowd boos the teams to the benches. We'll be back after the 60-second break. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Did you know Zock's Family Restaurant features 28 different sandwiches on their menu, all of which can be served alone or as a platter special? Zock's also offers salads with your choice of 15 different dressings, including Kraft fat and cholesterol-free flavors. A large chef salad with ham and everything is just $4.99 at Zock's. And they have pies and cakes and sundaes and so much more. When you're looking for a good place to eat, remember Zock's Family Restaurant, something good for everyone, on 231 South Edge of Crawfordsville.
Do you have water spots on your dishes and glassware? Are your clothes dull and dingy after laundering? Does your skin feel dry and rough? If so, you need a Puritan water conditioning unit. Puritan Soft Water turns clothes whiter and makes dishes sparkle. Puritan Soft Water keeps your skin smooth and your hair shining. Puritan has over 40 models to choose from. Puritan Water Conditioning, 216 Lafayette Avenue, Crawfordsville. Phone 362-6340. Puritan, another name for soft water.
Back once again at Wisconsin Fieldhouse with 3:21 to go. It's Indiana 81, Wisconsin 72. The Hoosiers are not out of trouble just yet, but obviously the three-point play by Matt Nover moments ago gave Indiana a lot more to deal with.
We've had two huge three-point plays. Damon Bailey a moment ago on a three-point shot from outside that was really a big basket. Indiana leading by 8 at that point. And then just now, Matt Nover. Matt Nover's having a great shooting afternoon. He's missed just one shot. He got that one blocked, actually. He's 6 of 7 from the field and 3 of 3 from the foul line. So he has been very significant in there. And, of course, he's got 10 rebounds along with an assist. So Matt Nover has played himself quite a ball game. Indiana is 18-0, Don, when they've scored 80 points or more. They've got 81, so if you believe those kind of things, the Hoosiers must have the advantage here.
Well, the four players that normally score the most points for Indiana are the four players right now that have double digits in this ball game. Bob Knight brought the team back over to huddle up just one more time there for a moment, and I know what he was saying out there, fellas. You just got to go out there and play like there's no way that they can beat you.
It's a three-minute season now, 3 minutes and 21 seconds. Wisconsin's really turned up the defense, I think, in the last 6 or 8 minutes, and that's been the significant thing.
Badgers will have it. Jeff Peterson will inbound to Tracy Webster. Webster will bring it up. Chris Reynolds, who's been in his back pocket much of the day defensively, is there again. He bounces to Eli. Eli gets it outside to Peterson. Back off to Webster on the right wing. He kicks it to Kilbride, who drives it inside. Now to Finley for a three try. It's no good. And the rebound batted away from Cheney. Now thrown away by Kilbride as Greg Graham comes up with it. He gets it away to Reynolds. Back to Greg Graham. And the Hoosiers have it once again. Now, Graham across the timeline. Greg, left side to Damon Bailey. Bailey outside to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds, as they spread the floor, bring the offense out higher. Gives to Greg Graham on the left side. Graham on one dribble gives to Bailey. Damon looks for Calvert, can't find him. Backs it out of the dribble, drives it right to the baseline, cuts off, comes back out to Greg Graham with a pass, now to Chris Reynolds. They work the shot clock, it's down to 14, to Calvert. Outside to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds now with 10 seconds on the shot clock, turns around, in the corner, pass thrown away, Finley out of bounds. Michael Finley stepped out of bounds, but that was a bad pass by Chris Reynolds there.
4 seconds on the shot clock, they're going to have to put it up quick.
And Greg Graham is asking for more time to be put up there. I don't think they can.
If it was a turnover, they can, but whether they declared a turnover or not, I don't know.
The ball was touched by Finley, who stepped out of bounds. We'll see what's happening. I don't think they're going to change anything. It's 4 seconds on the shot clock.
Calvert Chaney will inbound it. He gets it into Greg Graham. Graham slides it down the 15-foot line, fires it up, and he scores on a foul. What a play by Greg Graham. That's his 26th point of the ball game. He'll go to the line with a chance at a three-point play that could break the Badgers back. 81-72 the score. And this, now they changed the scoreboard. It's actually 83-72. And the Hoosiers may have just locked this one up. Graham fires the free one in the knee. Got it to go home. Greg Graham has got 27 now. Indiana leads 84-72. Left side pass to Kilbride. Kilbride outside to Finley. Finley goes to Webster on the right wing. Throw it away. Picked off in there by Calvert Chaney. And the Hoosiers, I think, have locked it up. 2:02 to go. Here comes Graham to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds in backcourt. Starts it left. Drives it to the wing. Comes back outside to Graham. Greg with it now against Kilbride. He drives it right. Pulls up in the lane. Back out it comes to Reynolds. Indiana working the clock beautifully. Now Greg Graham against Kilbride. Turns around. Dribbles it in backcourt. Gives to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds in backcourt is fouled by Jeff Peterson. So Peterson comes back and reaches in and fouls Chris Reynolds. Bob Knight is asking Tom Rucker how you can't call that intentional, because he held on to him, trying not to let him get to the ball.
And he had no chance to get the ball. That's supposedly the key to it.
Chris will go to the line with 1 point, his only point on a 1-for-2 free throw effort in the first half. So Reynolds at the stripe, trying to add to the point total. He fires this one short. The rebound comes off to Kilbride. Down the floor to Tracy Webster. Indiana by 12. Down to 1:31 to go to Finley. Finley drives in the lane. Fires it outside to Webster. He pumps it off to Kilbride. Kilbride baseline. Scoop shot. No good. Peterson's reverse layup. No good. Knocked away and a foul call on Peterson. Jeff Peterson will be nailed on his first foul. Make it his third personal foul. I don't think I've done a very good job of that today. I don't think I've brought down anybody's personal foul total. That's Peterson's third. And now Matt Nover goes to the line. Nover with 15 points in this ball game. And Indiana up 12 with 1:19 to go, and that sends the fans scurrying toward the exits. Matt Nover eyes the attempt, fires it up in the air, and he got it. Matt Nover has regained his shooting touch from the line. That is his fourth in a row in this game, his 16th point, and he eyes the second and got the short pounce. I put the kiss on him again, but the Hoosiers lead by 13. Here's Webster. Cross courts it to Kilbride to Finley for a three try. It's off the rim. No. Rebound. Matt Nover for Indiana. Off to Damon Bailey. Bailey clears it out of trouble to Greg Graham. Back to Bailey it goes. Damon will roar it up the floor, and he fires it to Matt Nover across the timeline to Calvert. Chaney has it ripped out of his hands by Finley. And down the floor, it's Finley with the basketball, and the scoop shot is good. Finley scores his 23rd point. Timeout by Wisconsin, apparently. And Bob Knight and the whole coaching staff for Indiana was up and upset about the fact that Calvert didn't draw the foul call. But that didn't happen. Nevertheless, Indiana leads by 11, 85-74, with 47.8 seconds to go. Bob Knight's going to bring Todd Leary into the ball game to put another free throw shooter in the contest. He will obviously take the place of Chris Reynolds.
Well, that basket that Finley just got closed down a drought that Wisconsin had gone through. Wisconsin had not scored since the 4:18 mark, in which they, at that point, were trailing by only 6 points. So Indiana turned up its defense a bit, holding away the Wisconsin Badgers, and at the same time converted on two three-point plays the old-fashioned way, which is something unusual these days. Most of your three-pointers come from the shot. But Indiana, which now hitting free throws at a rate of 14 out of 17, however, have hit only one out of their last three, so they have got to make free throws, because as they come down, you know Wisconsin's going to foul in this last 47 seconds.
Well, Indiana with 47.8 seconds away from winning their 17th Big Ten game, Max, and Bob Knight's going to have a monopoly on the most wins of Big Ten conference play for a single season. Indiana
or Indiana University will have, and Knight will have three of the four. Indiana went 18-0 in 1975, 18-0 in 1976, 17-1 in 1953, and it looks like they're going to go 17-1 in 1993. And obviously, there's lots of omens to think about there, Max. In 1953, the Hoosiers won the national championship for the second time under Branch McCracken, and Bob Knight's looking for number four.
Yeah, I hope that is the kind of omen that you get these kind of days. Of course, boy, you just you hold your breath when you think things like that, because so many things can happen in a big tear in the NCAA. You've really got it. You got to play well. You got to be good, but you got to have a little luck along the way.
So Damon Bailey will inbound for IU. The Hoosiers going to have to go against full court pressure here, and probably a pretty quick foul. Chris Reynolds stays in the ball game, however, for Indiana. Damon Bailey will inbound. In fact, Matt Mover's the guy who went to the sideline. So the Hoosiers have a very small but very quick lineup in there. And Bailey will inbound it. Gets it in to Gray Graham. Graham bounces back to Damon. Damon brings it up the court, clears to Calvert. Chaney now dribbles it across the timeline through three players, stops, looks, turns, clears to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds back to Calvert, and there's a foul.
Boy, if that isn't intentional.
Lewis Eli nailed on the personal as Chris Reynolds touched the ball. You knew they were going to try and foul Reynolds. So Eli has called for the foul. That is his fourth of the afternoon. And Chris Reynolds will be the man going to the line. Matt Nover comes back in for defensive purposes. And Brian Kelly is in for Wisconsin. At the stripe, Chris Reynolds, 1 point to his credit on 1 of 3 free throw shooting today, and this one drops. Now, Chris has got his second point of the afternoon, and it's 86-74. He can add a 13th point to the lead if he hits number two with 35 seconds to go. And he does. Nothing but net as Chris Reynolds has got three, and the Hoosiers lead 13. Here's Webster across the timeline, left side to Kilbride. Kilbride looks back out to Webster. A long three is good. Tracy Webster's got 15. That's his third three of the game. Here's Greg Graham up court to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds now has it stripped out of bounds. Brian Kelly banged it, and Indiana will get the basketball. Here's Todd Leary checking in for IU. Leary comes back into the ball game now, and this time it'll be for Chris. And now Calvert Chaney will trigger it in. Chaney looks, finally gets it in to Greg Graham, and he's hacked immediately. Kilbride and Finley were both there, so was Brian Kelly. And this one will go on Andy Kilbride. Well, Kilbride's had himself a career day. He's been outstanding. He had 20 points in this ball game, including 5 3-point field goals today. Greg Graham to the free throw line, 27 points this afternoon. 22 of those in the first half, and he misses that free throw. He'll try to make the lead 11 if he hits number two. Greg fires it and missed it again. He missed them both. That's most unusual for him. Here come the Wisconsin Badgers. Down to 10 seconds, however. Bounce pass to Kilbride. Three on the way. In and out, no. Rebound Damon Bailey, and that'll be the ball game. Bailey has it knocked away, and they're going to give it to Wisconsin. The Badgers will have it. It won't matter. We're down to 2.7. The inbound to Kilbride. He fires an NBA three. It is good, and that's the ball game. Andy Kilbride's 23rd point of the day is 6-3, but it means nothing as the Hoosiers will walk from Wisconsin Fieldhouse this afternoon. Victors over the Badgers, 87-80. And Indiana wraps up a brilliant Big Ten Conference basketball campaign at 17-1. We'll be back to recap this game for you in a moment. Let's pause for the 60-second network timeout.
Game's heating up, Bob. Look at that.
I don't believe it, Bob.
The coach is bringing in
a Canon NP6060 from Copyright.
A Canon NP6060, Bob?
The copier that shoots a copy a second.
Holds 6,100 sheets of paper.
And has Copyright's exclusive total lifetime coverage.
With service in 4 hours or they pay you.
And a lifetime money-back guarantee.
No wonder Copyright's Indiana's biggest.
Copyright, the smart choice.
That's the Canon NP6060.
From Copyright.
Put it on your office team.
Call Copyright.
And do it today,
if not sooner.
University Broadcasting Company is proud to bring you IU basketball. University Broadcasting serves Indiana with the finest in sports radio. University Broadcasting Company operates two sports networks and seven radio stations, including WHHH, Hoosier 96 in Indianapolis, WBWB, B97 in Bloomington, WGCT in Ellettsville, and WAZY, Z96 in Lafayette. University Broadcasting Company is Indiana's radio broadcasting company. Thanks for listening.
Well, back once again at Wisconsin Fieldhouse for the 1993 regular season campaign comes to a close as the Indiana Hoosiers wrap up their 28th victory of the year against just three losses, winning today over the Wisconsin Badgers 87-80 here at Wisconsin Fieldhouse and performing brilliantly in the process throughout much of this ball game. The Badgers did come back in the second half and make a contest out of it, but Indiana hung on for the win and their 17th of the Big Ten season against just one defeat there, and that is the second best record in Big Ten history for any conference team, and it ties an Indiana team from 1953 with that mark. The only better, 1975 and 1976, when again, it was the Hoosiers who went perfect 18-0 back-to-back seasons. All right, let's look at the individual scoring on the day. First of all, for the Wisconsin Badgers, Andy Kilbride with a career afternoon. 23 points today that included 6 three-point field goals. Michael Finley had another outstanding performance, getting his average. He scored 23 as well to co-lead the Wisconsin ball club. Tracy Webster had 15 this afternoon. Louis Eli had 9. Jeff Peterson had 6. 2 for Damon Harrell. 2 for Grant Johnson, Otto McDuffie, Adam Carl, Jason Johnson, and Brian Kelly all were held scoreless in today's ball game for Wisconsin. So the Badgers, three players, double figures, Finley and Kilbride, 23 each, and Tracy Webster with 15. For Indiana, Chris Reynolds had 3, Damon Bailey had 13. Matt Nover scored 16 this afternoon. Calbert Cheney had 22. Greg Graham, a sensational first half with 22 points. He added 5 more in the second half, 27 for the ball game to lead all scorers in this one. 2 points for Brian Evans, 2 points for Todd Leary, 2 points for Pat Knight. Pat Graham played but did not score. So Indiana today with 4 players in double figures, led by Greg Graham's 27, 22 for Cheney, 16 for Nover, and 13 for Damon Bailey. We'll be back to recap the team scoring in a moment, right after we pause for the 60-second network and make that a local timeout. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Some home equity credit makes people uneasy, but not Equity Reserve at National City Bank. Equity Reserve is a no-nonsense, variable-rate credit line for fiscally responsible people who use common sense and good judgment. Right now at National City Bank, you can receive 7.75 APR and no closing cost. Appraisal fee may be assessed. So stop by a nearby National City Banking office to apply for your Equity Reserve credit line. Then relax. National City Bank, going the distance for you at all Montgomery County locations and equal housing lender.
Horner Buick Pontiac Chrysler is overstocked with new and used cars. Bad weather kept many of you from taking advantage of Horner's February tax sale. Well, they're going to have a snow sale. John Horner is snowed under with new Buicks, Pontiacs, and Chryslers and low-mileage used cars. Jeeps, vans, Dakota trucks, and Grand Ams. They've got them all, and they're on sale right now during the March snow sale. They got to sell some of these cars, so stop in today at Horner's Corner, downtown Crawfordsville.
Well, back once again at Wisconsin Fieldhouse, where Indiana's Hoosiers defeat the Wisconsin Badgers this afternoon, 87-80. A solid performance by IU, and both Calbert Cheney and Greg Graham right now are being interviewed on the floor by CBS. So obviously a very happy couple of players right there. But, Max, a tough ball game in the second half for this Indiana ball club.
Well, Indiana won this thing basically in the first half with some really outstanding shooting because their second half did not reflect that same kind of shooting. In the first half, Indiana shot 61.8% on 21 of 34. But in the second half, they were able to hit only 11 of 24 for just 45.8. And that was thanks largely toward the end there. At one point in the second half, they were hitting just 27% on 2 baskets out of about 8 or 9 shots at that point. For Wisconsin, on the other hand, they did exactly the opposite. They shot only 36.7 in the first half, 11 of 30, but they came back and hit 19 out of 33 in the second half, 57.5. So for the game, Indiana finishes shooting 32 of 58, 55%. Wisconsin 30 of 63 for 48%. From three-point range, Indiana finishes the afternoon 7 of 15, 47%. They took only three shots in the second half from three-point range and hit on one of them. Wisconsin, on the other hand, shot 10 of 21 from three-point range, 48%, as they had a good second half to go with that first half, in which they hit 5 out of 10 three-point shots in the second half. Foul shooting was very good for both teams here today. For Wisconsin, they finished shooting a percentage of 83% on 10 of 12. They were 6 for 6 in the second half. Indiana shot 676% from the free throw line. They had an exceptionally good first half, 5 of 6, and at one point were 13 of 14, but they finished up just 16 of 21. So they missed four foul shots out of their last seven. Rebounding, Indiana out-rebounded the Wisconsin Badgers by a 32-30 margin, as Matt Nover had a great rebounding afternoon with 10 rebounds to lead Indiana. For the Wisconsin Badgers, their leading rebounder was Kelly and Eli with 5 rebounds each. Kilbride and Finley each had 4 rebounds. Turnovers, Indiana finishes with 9 turnovers, the same number as do the Wisconsin Badgers, but Indiana had only 3 turnovers in the first half, but were forced into 6 turnovers in the second half. On the other hand, the Wisconsin Badgers, 5 turnovers in the first half and 4 in the second half. Well, individually tonight, Bailey finishes 5 of 9 from outside. He was 1 for 1 from the free throw line. Cheney was 9 of 15. Nover today, 6 of 7. Greg Graham, who had 22 points in the first half, finishes up 10 of 16. Reynolds missed all 3 that he took. Leary was 1 for 3. Pat Graham, 0 for 2. And Evans was 1 for 3. Webster, who was 3 of 9, Finley, who was 3 of 11 in that first half, finished up 9 of 21. So he hit 6 of 10 shots in the second half. Eli was 4 of 6. Webster was 6 of 11 in the field. And Kilbride, who was outstanding, hit 7 out of 11 from the field today, including a whole host of three-point shots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 out of a total of 8 from the field. So he was absolutely outstanding. Well, the Badgers never got closer than 6, Don, but they got there on a couple of occasions after Indiana held a 22-point lead at halftime, 53-31. They got it down to 71-65 with 7 minutes to be played. They got it down to 78-72 with 4 minutes and 18 seconds to be played. But Indiana then put it away, winning it by 7, 87-80.
Well, a big win for Indiana today, and it's a great way to close out the campaign. They are now 17-1 of the Big Ten, as we said already, documenting, of course, the fact that they are the second winningest team in Big Ten history as far as a single-season performance is concerned, tied only with a 53 national championship squad from IU, and, of course, up one by both the 75 and 76 IU ball clubs, who went unbeaten at 18-0. At 28-3, the Hoosiers, of course, conclude the regular season. And now, of course, it's the NCAA tournament. Seedings and pairings will be announced this afternoon on CBS, late this afternoon, actually early this evening at 6:30. And the Hoosiers will find out how they're seated, where they'll be going. Obviously, the anticipated story will be the number one seed in the Midwest. But again, that is still up in the air, and we'll see late this afternoon. The final again, 87-80 Indiana. Today's ball game brought to you in part by Indiana Gas. For efficiency, comfort, and a cleaner environment, natural gas, your best energy value season after season. By your local Napa Auto Parts store. Napa, because there are no unimportant parts. By your local Amoco Certicare Repair Centers. By the Hoosier Lottery, where you've got to play to win. By State Farm Insurance and more than 500 State Farm agents throughout Indiana. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By the real estate professionals at the 121 Century 21 offices in Indiana. By True Value Hardware. Got a tough job? You can do it with True Value Hardware stores. By Squadron Herbicide for a higher level of soybean weed control. And by Indiana's Rural Electric Cooperatives, consumer-owned for service excellence. Our special thanks today to our studio producer,
Gary Klein, to our statistician Greg Elkin. Now this is Don Fisher for Max Gervin inviting you to stay tuned next for the IU postgame show. We'll be rejoining you in just a couple of minutes. So long, everybody.
TGI Fridays presents Dr. Ruth with turn-ons.
Women crave for romance and passion. Men want to save money. Fridays 2 for $20 time is perfect for both. They can share an appetizer, each have an entree and share a dessert, all for only $20.
Pick an appetizer, two entrees, and a dessert from selected menu items, all for $20. That's 2 for $20 time at participating Fridays. Everyone looks forward to Fridays.
Tax and gratuities not included.
So we're right in the middle of dinner, and we get one of those calls trying to get us to switch from AT&T
to MCI.
Right. They said Dave gave them our number.
Put them on to me, too, about this friends and family thing.
And me.
You talking about Dave giving out your numbers? Where is he, anyway?
Yeah, let's talk to him.
Hey, Dave!
Hi!
What about all those calls we're getting thanks to you?
What's going on? Yeah.
At AT&T, your friends are your business. Keeping you connected to them is ours. So if anyone tries to get you to switch, you can simply say,
it's just not worth it.
Imagine if drug abusers said exactly what was on their minds.
Hi, Jim, you got a minute?
Only if it's a quick minute, Steve.
Well, it's the Anderson file. We should talk about it.
No, listen, I'd love to, but I was just about to snort some coke.
What'd you say? Snort coke?
That's right, cocaine. You know, blow, nose candy. I do it all day.
Not your typical office conversation, but consider this. 1 in 7 working Americans uses illegal drugs.
But what about the Anderson file?
Tell you what. Let me duck into the men's room, do a couple of lines, and I'll be right with you.
Of course, drug abusers aren't this candid about their problem, but sooner or later, their problem speaks for itself.
Okay, got my head cleared. Now, about that Peterson file.
Anderson file, Jim.
What can you do for someone who needs help? Give them this number, 1-800-662-HELP. That's 1-800-662-HELP. It's the number of the National Drug Abuse Helpline. It's free. It's confidential. And it just may be the help they need. This message brought to you by the Partnership for a Drug-Free America.
Your allergies are more than a sneeze and a sniffle. Your allergies hurt from sinus pain and pressure and headache. Fortunately, there's new relief from Benadryl, the leader in allergy relief. New Benadryl Allergy Sinus Headache Formula. It relieves your allergy symptoms, sinus pain, and pressure, even your headache. Remember, when allergies come on strong enough to hurt, new Benadryl Allergy Sinus Headache Formula comes on stronger. Use as directed.
You're listening to 1550 AM WCBL and 103.9 FM WIMC Crawfordsville.
Once again, this is Don Fisher and Max Gervin with the IU postgame show. A review of today's ball game, in which Indiana closes the regular season with a victory over the Wisconsin Badgers 87-80. Norm Ellenberger, of course, is always our guest in the postgame. And Norm, this afternoon, a clinic in the first half and then one of those hang-on jobs in the second half.
Well, they... You know, I just left the locker room, and, you know, Coach Knight was really felt good that we got up here and we either escaped or we tricked them or whatever we had to do to get a win and get home. And one of the things that the last thing I just heard him say before I left the room was, you know, there's only been two teams in the history of the Big Ten that's ever had a 17-1 record, and that was this our outfit's record this year, and he was really proud of him.
Well, he should be. This ball club just performed, I think, brilliantly throughout the season, and I think again today really took Wisconsin out of the ball game in the first half. They kind of got back into it a little bit in the second half, but let's face facts here. The Big Ten championship is all wrapped up. You don't have a lot of emotion going for you today. You're simply playing out the string, and sometimes that's difficult to do.
Well, it's not that we didn't want to come up here. Well, if you did, maybe the coaches, I don't think we wanted to come up here. If you'd really put my feet to the fire, you know, none of us wanted to come up here. You know, we'd won the thing, and the kids have got to feel somewhat the same way. You know, they want to go play, but at the same time, you know, we got the big thing starting next week, and you know, you'd like to get along to that, and then I think this is really puts it in the proper perspective. You take a Wisconsin who's got a couple of real dandy ball players and then a lot of good ball players and a brand new coach, a brand new situation in here, and they're going to play. And, And while this kind of a team that Wisconsin is this year couldn't maybe get up for a Northwestern or get up for a Penn State, of which they got dusted by those two teams here just recently, I'll promise you they're going to get up for an Indiana when Indiana comes to town. And they're going to play all 40 minutes, you know. We played about 25, and fortunately that was enough.
All right, we'll be back and talk more about this ball game in a moment. But first, let's pause for the 60-second timeout.
Hi, this is Willard Scott for True Value. We'd like to recognize the Indiana University basketball team, better known as the Hoosiers, for their hard work all season. Every college basketball player dreams of making the pros and getting a nice bonus. But to clean your home like a pro and also get a nice bonus, you need Simple Green Degreaser. It cleans everything from clothes to car engines. And when you buy a 67-ounce size, you'll get a bonus 8-ounce bottle, both for just $5.99 at your local True Value hardware store or home center.
University Broadcasting Company is proud to bring you IU basketball. University Broadcasting serves Indiana with the finest in sports radio. University Broadcasting Company operates two sports networks and seven radio stations, including WHHH, Hoosier 96 in Indianapolis, WBWB, B97 in Bloomington, WGCT in Ellettsville, and WAZY, Z96 in Lafayette. University Broadcasting Company is Indiana's radio broadcasting company. Thanks for listening.
Back once again, we're at Wisconsin Fieldhouse, where Indiana is victorious today, 87-80. Norm, as we talk about this ball game today, another terrific first half performance from Greg Graham. He had 22 first half points, finished the game with 27, but still this guy is flat shooting the lights out as the season comes to a close.
You know, as this thing wound down, you know, you looked, and I was a little bit surprised. I looked in the season end stats of the Big Ten, and boy, you can find Greg Graham all over the place. And that's why I kind of like our ball club now. I think we're really improving, and one of the big reasons is because of Greg Graham. You know, and Bailey's playing better, and he's more consistent now than he's been for a while. And Nova and Larry comes off the bench and gets you a basket. Boy, I tell you, if you got a kid that you can put off the bench and in the next 90 seconds he's going to get you a basket, you know, that he's invaluable. So anyhow, all of them are really playing well, and we're going to need to be with what's ahead of us.
One of the things that you did in the first half, I think, has been important all year long when you come up against a team that likes to press. You simply play with patience, get the good shot, and knock it down, and that just wipes out a full-court press.
Well, we had we talked about the shots that Greg hit from the outside, and we were able to dump it down inside, and Nover got two or three, and we executed pretty well, which we didn't do the second half, but that's all, you know, that's all mute now, and it's time to get on and get out of this cold weather. Gee whiz, was it cold here this morning. Oh, man.
Norm, you mentioned Matt Nover a minute ago. He was really good shooting today, 6 of 7. Hit some free throws, 10 rebounds. That's got to be an important statistic.
Right. And those were big defensive rebounds. You know, this is a bigger team than we are. And we're, of course, that. What else is new, huh? I mean, that's the way it's going to get worse than that. Matt carried the brunt of that for quite a while.
I would have to think that Damon Bailey's three-point shot with about 5 minutes
big
to
time.
Go, that
big time.
Really was a crucial.
You
point.
Know, and that's the kind of gutty kid that he is. You know, he'll step right up and take his swing. There's no doubt about it. And you know, we weren't looking necessarily for a three. We just come off of a timeout and had a little stuff set up and a little bit of patience. But he had all the confidence in the world. And boy, it was nothing but net.
I thought another key today individually was Chris Reynolds' defensive effort against Tracy Webster.
Yeah, did a nice job when the game was still on the line. He did a good job there. And Pat Graham didn't have his normal day. That, you know, Pat's hadn't played a lot in 2 years, and he was just a half a count behind. This is a quick game. This is a quick team like Ohio State, and Pat was like he had still had his cast on out there about half the time. But he'll come back out of that. And then this morning, we go down to the pregame meal or pregame breakfast, and you got Brian Evans sitting over there in real dark sunglasses because of an eye infection that hit him in the middle of the night, and we had some problems there. But our frontliners carried us through.
Well, Norm, as we close out the regular campaign, all you can say was it was simply brilliant. 28-3, 17-1 in the Big Ten. One of the great seasons of all time in Indiana basketball history.
Well, there's no doubt about that, and it could even get better if we if we can just kind of come on, keep shooting the ball, and we're sure glad to get out of Wisconsin. How many people here? This is a loud place.
11,250.
Wow, 11,000 people and 22,000 coats. Everybody's got to wear two coats around here.
All right, Norman, congratulations on the win. Get back home and enjoy it because the NCAA comes up next. Find out who you play today.
Well, we get that this afternoon, and then I don't think we'll practice tonight, but I'll guarantee you we'll have some coaching meetings tonight.
All right, Norm Ellenberger, our guest in the post game, as always. We'll be back with a final thought after the 60-second timeout.
Dear Hooked on Phonics, reading was one of the most difficult subjects for our son. It was a frustrating problem that even began to affect his self-esteem. Hooked on Phonics ended our struggle. The difference in his self-confidence is obvious to everyone, especially his teachers. Thanks to Hooked on Phonics, we now feel more confident as parents, too. Signed, J.H. Emporia, Virginia. For Hooked on Phonics plus SRA Reading Laboratories, call 1-800-ABCDEFG.
It's me. Your mouth? Yes, your mouth. You know, with all this dental work you've got, I'm glad you chew Freedent gum, because it doesn't stick to most dental work. But maybe you don't know about new Winter Fresh Freedent. See, when you chew Winter Fresh Freedent, it cools your mouth. That's me. So it freshens your breath, which everyone appreciates. So do your mouth a favor, okay? Try new Winter Fresh Freedent.
Winter Fresh Freedent. When your mouth feels cooler, your breath feels fresher.
And your mouth ought to know.
One of the Big Ten. Indiana led today by Greg Rams, 27 points. Calvert Cheney added 22. Nover, 16. Bailey with 13. Top scorer for Wisconsin, 23 each for Kilbride and Finley. That's a career high for Kilbride. And also 15 for Tracy Webster today, Max.
Well, Indiana finishes up shooting 55%, thanks largely to that 61.8 shooting in the first half. Wisconsin, on the other hand, shoots 47%, thanks mainly to their 57% shooting in the second half. Both teams hitting three-point shots very well. Indiana 50% Indiana 46% on 7 of 15. Wisconsin 10 of 21, 47% also.
So Indiana wraps up an outstanding 1993 regular season. The Hoosiers now find out this evening who they'll play in the NCAA tournament first round, where they'll be seated, and the pairing. And, of course, it's expected to be the Midwest. We don't want to speculate beyond the point, but obviously Indiana is considered to be a number one seed. And the Midwest Regional, if they are assigned there, very hopefully will be the Hoosier Dome in Indianapolis. I can tell you this, fans, there are no tickets available from Indiana University. That's one thing we talked about on the way up here today. The NCAA allots you just 250 tickets to the university. Most of those tickets will be utilized, of course, for the basketball team, family members, that type of situation. Don't even think about trying to get a ticket from IU. You might as well call the box office at the Hoosier Dome starting tomorrow, because that's the only place there are tickets remaining, and they are all, as we understand it, balcony seats.
That's right. There aren't enough tickets to make even a public sale, as far as IU is concerned, once they take care of the various things they're obligated to do so, and as a result, they don't even make a public sale.
So, Indiana, a winner today over Wisconsin, 87-80. All of our affiliate stations down the line, you have the information on how to contact us tomorrow, or actually on Tuesday, regarding our time and so on for our pregame on probably Friday night of this coming week. But again, we'll not speculate any further. Just simply say Indiana's in the NCAA tournament. Where and when, we'll know later this evening. Until then, this is Don Fisher. Don't forget the
Fiction Show.
The NCAA Basketball Championship Selection Show, sponsored by Pizza Hut, who reminds you that anytime's a great time to stop and smell the pizza.
Hi, everybody. March Madness is in the air. I'm Jim Nance, along with Bill Raftery, Billy Packer. You ready, guys, to get
it
started?
Let's go.
Waste no time. Let's get out to Kansas City. James Brown with the announcement. JB, take it away.
All right, Jimmy, thank you very much, and we will waste no time cutting right to the chase for the 64-team field for this year's tournament. And let's start with the number one seeds in the four regions. All right, in the East, no surprise there. North Carolina, the top seed. The last time they were number one, they went all the way to the championship game and won it in 82. In the Midwest, it's Indiana. Masterful job by Bobby Knight and company. Rick Pitino's Kentucky Wildcats, the number one seed in the Southeast, and Michigan, playing arguably the toughest schedule in the country. They are number one in the West. Okay, let's take a look in the East first. These are Thursday, Saturday games in Winston-Salem. Number one ranked North Carolina, as we mentioned, they will be taking on the 16th seed there, East Carolina. The Pirates, first team since Montana State in 86 to come into the tournament with a losing record. The eighth seed, Rhode Island, congratulations to Al Skinner, first appearance since 88. They will take on Purdue and their sensational sophomore, Glenn Robinson. Brian Mahoney, sensational job at St. John's, fifth seed. He's the Big East Coach of the Year. St. John's will meet Texas Tech. James Dickey, the head coach there, second-year coach, magnificent job. Arkansas will hold down the fourth seed in the East, and the Razorbacks of Nolan Richardson will take on Holy Cross. George Blaney in his 21st season at his alma mater. Now, these games are Friday-Sunday games in Syracuse in the East. The number six seed, Virginia. Jeff Jones, well, I tell you, they started off 11-0, finished 8-9, but they're in the big dance. They will be taking on Manhattan, the Jaspers' first appearance since 1958, the same year the head coach Fran Fraschello was born. Happy birthday. Number three seed goes to Massachusetts. John Calipari went back to his old coaching style. They're in the NCAAs, taking on the team from the Ivy League's 14th-seeded Pennsylvania, undefeated in Ivy League play. The number seven seed, New Mexico State, Swift, Sam Crawford, the man there, as they will play Nebraska, the number 10 seed. All right, the number two seed, Cincinnati, synonymous with defense there. Number 15, Coppin State, Fang Mitchell, the head coach there. They were undefeated in MEAC play. Now to the Midwest. These are Thursday, Saturday games in Chicago. The number six seed, the California Golden Bears, under interim coach Todd Bozeman, went 9-1 since the firing of Lou Campanelli. They will play the LSU Fighting Tigers. Dale Brown's team did it on the strength of postseason play. The Duke Blue Devils hold down a number three seed in the Midwest. Mike Krzyzewski's team will take on the 14th seed, Southern Illinois, first appearance since 1977. The BYU Cougars hold down the number seven seed. They will play 10th-seeded SMU. John Shoemate, remarkable turnaround job for the Mustangs. Number two seed, the Kansas Jayhawks, stumbled a bit in postseason play, but Roy Williams' team is in, and the Kansas Jayhawks will play Ball State, the Cardinals' third appearance in the last 5 years. And Friday, Sunday location in Indianapolis, of course, the number one ranked Indiana Hoosiers, Bob Knight's team, maybe without Allen Henderson, will take on the 16th seed, Wright State, just their sixth season in Division I play. They won the Division II championship back in 83. Number eight seed, New Orleans, the Privateers, have a senior by the name of Irvin Johnson. Don't call him magic, but he can play. The number nine seed, Xavier of Ohio, out of the MCC, seventh appearance in the last 8 years for Pete Gillen. The number five seed is Oklahoma State, coached by the master, Eddie Sutton. They are in the tournament. Will take on Marquette, Kevin O'Neill. Super job there, first appearance since 1983. Denny Crum, the old hand, back in the tournament again. 17 appearances and two national championships. And the Cardinals will take on Delaware Fighting Blue Hens. Second consecutive appearance for the Delaware Blue Hens. All right, now that's half the field. 32 teams, 32 more to go. And we'll bring you up today with the Southeast and the West for the 64-team field right